Welcome to Comic Artist Pro Secrets. I'm Ethan Van Sciver. Trying to get a signal. Oh, there we go. Finally. All right, everyone. Good to be with you today. Yes. Comic Artist Pro Secrets. I am Ethan Van Sciver, 26-year veteran of the comic book industry, whatever's left of it. World's most charming and disarming, elegant and eloquent, humble because I often fumble, man. Yes. It's good to be with you guys. All right. What a day. Had a nice conversation with an old friend, a comic book artist, you know, talked about plans, talked about, you know, look, the future is what the future is. There's no controlling it. There's no going back to the past. You can do a comic book series, sure. You can do a comic book series for the mainstream, but it ain't going to sell. Get ready for it. Talking to him about, you know, working 14-hour days, having a whole big family, working 14-hour days, drawing a comic book that isn't going to pay you very much, that's probably going to sell, might sell 20,000 copies in this market. And I said, my friend, I'm talking to you on a, you know, a swing in my backyard, you know, just a little porch swing kind of thing. And I'm spending all my time with my family. It's great. I draw a little bit at night, but I mean, I want to do one book a year. And that's the thing. I mean, doing one book a year, maybe 100 pages a year is good. I think that's ideal right now. And that'll leave you all kinds of time for your family. But at the same time, you know, I mean, I can help you with that. I can show people how to do this. I can show people how to make this situation work for them. Do I recommend it? Do I recommend it for you? No, I don't recommend. I do not recommend professionals join ComicsGate. I always discourage them. I always say, you are not ComicsGate. Don't think you're ComicsGate. Do not do this. This is, you have to have balls to be in ComicsGate. You have to be ready to fight all the time, to fight for what's yours. The benefits are good. We have a good benefit package here. But you do have to fight all the time. I mean, it's like, oh, everyone, if only I could just radiate the love that I feel in my heart for everyone at all times. Let me see who's here. Let's see. Varandian Vigilani says, avert your eyes, mortals. Zeno the Stoic, Potato Cam. It doesn't look that bad. Let's see. Legendary Uriah says, throw Mike off a roof. I don't think we need to throw Mike off a roof. Level 4 says, what's going on now? Nothing. It's just, you know, it's been a heck of a weekend, and some things are starting to, you know, things are starting to become more clear. And that's the thing. It's like, you know, you can, you should always wait and get as much information as you possibly can before you make choices. Always get information. For example, Neil Adams, legendary comic book artist. If you had said to me, Ethan, is he nuts? I would have said no. Okay. But I would be speaking from ignorance. I would be speaking from ignorance if I told you that. Look at this. I've never seen, this is Neil Adams' Twitter page. I have never seen anything like this. My goodness. Let me hold on. Let's scroll up here. Neil Adams is a legendary comic book artist. I'm going to go all the way to the top. Legendary comic book artist who basically created the Batman of the 1970s that bled into the 1980s that led to the Frank Miller Batman. I mean, he really made Batman into kind of a darker, more serious character, the Batman that you know and love today. He only has 24,600 followers. What? Let me check me here. Hold on a second. Where's my account? How do I do? Oh, my profile. That's how I would find out. Oh, I have 37.7 thousand. Wow, I must be Twittering. I must be Twittering better than Neil Adams. I wonder why that is. Let's find out. You fucks are taking a month off in the middle of a congressional war with a mad president to let him ply his un-American trade. You send young men to fight your wars 7 days a week, and you desert your country while it burns. You all should be drawn and quartered. Okay. That seems rational. I understand. Oh, look, Pocket Jack's Comics follows Neil Adams. That's interesting, too. That's an interesting factoid. Scrolling down. That's it. Sell arms to the greatest terrorist nation in the Arab world, Saudi Arabia. Saudi Arabia? Congress has no backbone and crumbles in the face of a madman. In the last election, why didn't you focus on the Senate as well? Spineless and stupid. Republican Congress has become the USA agent for Russia, and no one more so than Moscow, Mitch McConnell, and the blocker of legislation that curbs our sworn enemy, McConnell, who hates America and loves his purse. What is going on? What is going on in comics? What is going on in the world? What is going on exactly? I mean, and this, by the way, this doesn't stop. I mean, this just goes on. This kind of crazed static is so common right now in the comic book industry. You think that Neil has just decided to go, Neil's just decided to go all CNN and MSNBC on his Twitter, but a lot of comic book professionals feel this way. They've completely lost their minds. Do you all know that Donald Trump did not know and still does not know what drain the swamp actually means? It was presented as a theme during the election. He tried it and people approved. Surprised he used it. Do you understand? 4 question marks. 1, 2, 3, 4. So ask that question 4 times. Sad, he says. Sad. Have you ever been invited to be hosted, to be a guest of the royal family, to attend their Comic-Con in Saudi Arabia? You might want to find something better to do with that time. Like, oh, killing cockroaches, supporting Donald Trump. So unless I'm reading this incorrectly, people who support Donald Trump are cockroaches that should be killed. So it would be a better use of your time rather than visit Dubai. Beautiful Dubai, by the way. Those of you who haven't been to Saudi Arabia, Dubai is a lovely place. You might want to visit Dubai and get a little culture. You know, it's very, very like, you know, I don't know. It's upper class over there. So rather than do that, you might want to kill Republicans, or at least Trump supporters. That would be a better use of your time. Moscow Mitch enables Russia, and he and his wife are paid to do so. America's embarrassment and very real horror. Does he know and fear the fear and loathing that penetrates our minds when we see him approach the microphone? If you didn't have a hole in your head, nobody could penetrate your mind, sir. And I mean that with all due respect. I have I have respect. I have respect. Everyone's saying Dubai is in the United Arab Emirate. All right. Okay. Maybe it is a separate country. I don't know. Oh, my God. If you support Trump, sadly, make this clear. You are not a Republican. You are an ignorant bigot. I'm going to retweet this one. Oh, I'm going to retweet it. And also, yeah, like that. And hold on a second. What can I do? Shrug. Oh, frog. Oh, what else? Rainbow. Gay rights now. No, rainbow brute. That's not my gay rights now. Hold on. Doesn't matter. This is good enough. I don't know. Oh, salamander emoji. I use that one all the time. Love, innocent angel. Did I get them all? These are all the ones I use. Oh, and a winky face. Okay. Retweet. Dun-dun-dun-dun-dun. Hi, everyone. Hello, Darth Cisco. Schnick says, this isn't selling comics. No, I don't think it sells comics at all. Democrats and sane people, ironically, says Neil Adams. What happened in Germany when you people ignored Hitler and reacted instead of acting? It's begun in full force at the Mexican border and in the depths of the American government. Democrats are cowards and suck as the bully of the world's playground struts. And this goes on. So I'm not going to read any more of this insanity, but I'm just going to scroll down. First of all, let's just look. So this is a comic book artist. Let's count the number of crazed political tweets that have nothing to do with comics. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Well, that's kind of, they're saying if you get invited to go to a Comic-Con in Saudi Arabia, you're better off killing Trump supporters. That's a toss-up. Let's try again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, toss-up, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, impeach the monster. No, that's just, he's making fun of Delta Airlines. He's just making fun of Delta. Okay. Look at this. Neil's comic store. That's nice. He's soliciting commissions. That's great. That's great. The whole thing. Oh, this was San Diego Comic-Con. That's why, right back to it again. You Democrats have no balls. Like I see that and I'm like, yeah, I. Oh. And then I read the rest of it and I disagree with it. Like for a minute, I agree with it. I'm like, yeah, they are scrotumless. Yes, sir. They are eunuchs. Yes, sir. They are penisless. Their penislessness is apparent to all. And then I'm like, oh, never mind that. So all the way down here. I'm doing a signing at Krusty Bunkers. Sir, don't do a signing at Krusty Bunkers. This one here, another one. And then boom, right back to it. Congress, you have become more powerless. By the way, what makes you type these right here? What are these? What makes you type them like that? That makes me that looks crazy. You lose. By the way, also not addressed to anyone. Like nobody would see this. Nobody would see this tweet. I mean, he got 19 hearts for it, one retweet, but it isn't addressed. He didn't say at Mitch McConnell or anything like that, or at Nancy Pelosi, you know, he didn't say anything like that. It's just, you know, all right, commission, that's good. He is a rapist and currently torturing children on the border in the worst possible ways. He blames others and lies to deny. Yes, but his comic book got canceled. And he's been, you know, Vertigo closed down. But that's what a liar does. You knew he was a snake when you let him in, didn't you? Interesting. So we just go on and on and on and on. Now, people say, Ethan, why? Why does Comicsgate, why is it necessary? Why does it exist? Because the comic book industry is getting worse and worse and worse. And you think that Neil is like alone in this? You think that he's unique? He's not unique. This is normal behavior for comic book pros. This is how it is. This is the situation. It's absolutely insane, you know, it is insane. And, you know, as a comic book fan, you've got to read that and head for the hills. You've got to run for the hills. That's insulting stuff. It's crazy. I don't. Why? What is going on? What is going on? Are we seriously, like, is the world so messed up right now? Are people, like, living on the edge? People are living on the edge of insanity, and it seems like we're the only ones that are left, and we're fighting with each other. It's stupid. Obi-Wan says, this is the new rebranded name for Comicsgate Comics Makers. No, but it is funny. I would love to call, I mentioned this today. People said, why don't you rebrand Comicsgate? Because obviously Comicsgate's the problem, the word Comicsgate and not the people within it. And I said, well, if I did, I'd want it to be called Indie Comics Entertainment, or ICE for short. And therefore, I would make ICE t-shirts that would just be black with like ICE on it in big white letters. On the back, it would say Indie Comics, Indie Comics Entertainment. And on, it might say like, you know, gatekeeping our culture or something like that on the front. I don't know what it would say, but it would be, that would be what I would do if I had to change it. So here's your choice. Comicsgate or ICE, gatekeeping our culture. What do you think that you would be, what do you think would get us into more trouble? That's what we're looking at. By the way, Obi-Wan27883 is a new member of the channel. Thank you for joining. Brian O'Shea, thank you for a dollar. Professor Roman Dev says, more like the most hum bald man. Johnny in Cleveland is a new member. Thank you for joining. Obi-Wan27883 says, I'm making a choice with all the information to refund my copies of Earthworm Jim. Nobody treats my Uncle EBS like that. Well, I wouldn't recommend refunds for anybody. Refunds are a pain in the booty. Raging Golden Eagle says, Trump derangement level maximum. And Smile Titan says, don't talk politics with Neil Adams. Stick with the expanding Earth theory. That way you get the fun kind of crazy, not the Trump derangement syndrome. I want the fun kind of crazy. I'm with you, honestly. You know, I want the fun kind of lunacy. It's so dumb. I just read this stuff and I'm like, it's so, you know, the SJW, we're going to talk about a couple of words that I think SJWs have taken over, okay? And they mean something else. But one of the words that SJWs have taken over is the word toxic. And when it comes to toxic, I at first I think that's a word used to bully people. But hold on, let me invite some comic skaters in here. I think we could do that. But when you read those tweets, you start to understand what toxic actually means. It is a thing. Let's see. Oh, Cecil. I get a message from Cecil. He's like, you're getting fucked with. Are you all right? I'm okay, Cecil. I'm okay. I could use a nice cup of warm milk, a blankie, but I'm all right other than that. I'm going to invite Cecil in here too. We'll see if he can make it in. So toxic, when you read those tweets, that's what toxic means. That is what toxic means. That's unbreathable air. Looking at that guy going off about Trump with capital letters and lunacy, that just doesn't sell comics. You know, I mean, that's the least of it. It just doesn't sell comics. Darth Gavel says, sometimes it is good to forgive, forget, and reboot Hollywood. I forgive and forget. I forgive and then I forget everyone. I forgive you. Now forget you. I think that's probably the wisest choice in some situations. All right, hold on a second here. A lot of stuff's going on. A lot of stuff's going on in my Batcave command center. I've decided to call my man cave the persona non grotto. Okay, and that is. That is for people who have been canceled. Like, victims of cancel culture are all welcome down in my basement. So it is called the persona non grotto. Drinks are free. You're all welcome. Hold on one more second here, and we will get things going. Why is everything difficult? Oh, because I have no internet connection. Why is everything ridiculous all the time? Let me put this here. This would be easier for me, and it would make our show. It would make our show more delightful. All right, hold on. I can't use ICE. There's a pen and paper company, a pen and paper RPG company called ICE, Iron Crown Enterprises. Okay. So we're not going to do that. We won't use ICE. We feel like it would be copyright infringement. All right, Laser Pants Toy Junk is a new member. Thank you so much. Starman, thank you for 50CZK. He says, oh, we can now send super chats from my country. Interesting. This makes it my first super YouTube super chat. Take my cherry then, uncle. Okay, thank you. Obi-Wan says, can we have some fun topics like disavowing flat earth and embracing hollow earth? I feel like we can quit giving SJWs airtime and attention. I like it, though. I like talking about SJWs. Marxie says, wow, Uncle Lee, thank you for sharing my artwork. That piece has gotten more hits and likes than anything I've ever drawn. I appreciate the exposure. You're welcome. By the way, yeah, I mean, anytime you guys send me fan art of Cyberfrog, I'm going to retweet it, you know, and I will make sure that everybody sees it. So that is very appreciated, Marxie. Matt Horkin says, ice is a flash in the pan issue. It would be dated. That's true. Liam Gray says, love you, man. Ham Sandwich says, love your hair. Go hatless more. What's left of my hair? A little bit of fuzz. Watch my film, please. What's your film, Ham Sandwich? Greg Bowen says, wondering if you checked in on Tug since all this crap started. I think we need to follow Zach's example. You did say he's been a Cassandra for comics. Well, what's Zach's example? What should we do? People say, well, Zach left Twitter, and I think that was the best thing that he could do. Zach left Twitter because it was driving him insane. It was just like people were coming down on Zach like a ton of bricks. Antonio, is that you?
That is me. What's going on, player?
You know, just chilling.
Love the intro, by the way. It was awesome.
What intro? You like my Biggie Smalls?
Yeah, man. When I heard Biggie, I was like, I hyped up a little bit. I was like, all right.
People don't like my smooth jazz remixes of classic hip-hop. I think they like the hello one, you know.
Well, you did start this gangster shit, man.
I did. And now I'm trying to, you know, understand why people won't thank me for it. Properly, the way that I demand. Here's the thing. All right. So Zach left Twitter because he was being harassed nonstop. And he thought that it would be better for his mental health to leave Twitter. I don't think he left Twitter because it was a strategic choice. It was the best thing for his business. Although, I think that now he recognizes that being away from Twitter, he gets more work done. The problem with that is Zach probably sold more comics when he was on Twitter. And that's a fact. I mean, it's like when you have, you need all the various social media outlets in order to sell comics. And I always tell Zach that. I'm like, you need to get out and start talking more and talk more about what you think and your opinions. Let people know, not just on YouTube. You know, when your only station is YouTube, people don't know where to find you. New people can't find you. And thus his YouTube channel has slowed to a halt as well.
Yeah, but that's something I actually talked to him about when I had him on my channel. Because, you know, you can notice, I mean, you can track that on like Social Blade and stuff. You can notice that he kind of got stuck in a certain place. I've always heard like when you hit 100,000, that your growth is supposed to explode or something. But he's been kind of stuck at the same area. But I think his content's still good, though.
His content is good and it's getting better. For a little while, like Zach just decided I've had enough. Like I've had enough. This was supposed to be about comics. And, you know, I don't want to fight SJWs all the time because, I'm in a lawsuit. I'm in the middle of a lawsuit that I can't really talk about. And that's an important thing. The stuff that people really want to hear Zach talk about, he can't really talk about too much because this lawsuit has him in a holding pattern. That's the thing. It's like, what is Mark Waid's defense against what he did? You know, the only defense that Mark Waid can put on for what he did is that Zach deserved it. Now, this is a defense that isn't going to work because it's irrelevant, to the question of defamation or the question of tortious interference. He deserved it. That doesn't mean anything. But at the same time, you know, Zach is still really upset about that cum dumpster comment. Like he really, really regrets it. Zach regrets that. He regrets man in a wig. Oh man, I went through all this with him, and I, he would be like, we kind of changed places on that, because like I remember he got in so much trouble about Max Visaggio because he called Max Visaggio a man in a wig, and he would title videos Man in a Wig, you know.
Yeah, oh, trust me, yeah, I've been watching the channel for a long time.
Yeah, yeah.
So he brought me in the comics game. That's what brought me in the comics game, watching his channel.
Yeah, yeah, me too. Well, me too. Like, watching Zach's channel made me realize, you know, what I was doing wrong as a comic book pro, and just in terms of my business. But it didn't really matter, because, to be honest with you, when you're working for the mainstream, they don't want you to talk about the comics. You know, I mean, people, you know, Zach is like, well, they need to promote their comics more. DC used to kind of say, we'll do the promotion, you just shush up. You know, that was their kind of rule for everyone. And if you wanted to promote something, they'd encourage it as long as you went to them first and said, I would like to say this. And they would get back to you within the same day and say, you can say that. What a pain in the ass. The whole benefit, the whole wonderful thing about Twitter is its spontaneity. You can be impulsive. You know, you can call people a man in a wig. You know, I mean, that's like something that you want to do. You don't want to have to get permission for everything that you tweet. And that's kind of how the mainstream works. They don't want you. They do not want you to be a loose cannon out there promoting their shit. Shit. Antonio, say shit, but then come down hard on the T at the end.
Shit.
No, no, no. Harder, harder. Shit.
Shit.
Yeah.
Shit.
And bare your teeth when you do it like this. Shit. Like that. Okay. That's like angry. That might be Jersey. I don't know. I don't know where I got that. So in any case, that's why he's not really on Twitter. I feel like, and by the way, he hates Twitter now. And because he's not on Twitter, he tells everybody they need to be off of Twitter. And everybody goes, that's wise.
He's definitely told me to he's like, I'm going to tell you like I told Ethan, get off Twitter.
Yeah, he's like, everyone that I tell to get off Twitter thanks me. Yeah. There are a lot of things. There are a lot of burdens that I would like to lay down, that if I laid them down, I would thank myself. And I would advise other people to as well. I mean, like I said at the beginning of this live stream, I was telling an artist buddy of mine. I was like, dude, it's like, why are you? He's like, I'm doing this 6-issue miniseries and I'm doing something else. I was like, you are? At your age, you know, it's like, I don't know. I mean, you know, don't you want to just slow down a little bit? You know, I mean, your 20s are one thing. Your 20s and your 30s are one thing. Like, you really do want to just rock and roll. You're super ambitious. You know, money is tight, so you're working real hard. You know, but man, when you get in your mid-40s, it's just kind of like, I want to chill a little bit. Hey, Narwhal, how are you?
I'm good. How's it going, guys?
You know what? Do you have to wear the mask? Are you still wearing the mask? I guess you are. I mean, I know what you look like, Narwhal.
Yeah, it's like a branding thing, but I don't know if it's stupid, but it makes people, like, I think I mentioned this at Scott Adams. It makes people remember me as Soy Zorro. I'm going to sell shirts one day. I tried to sell already. Zorro. I sold one shirt, but you have to sell 10 in order for it to ship out to people and get any money. I'm like, someone out there wants to buy a Soy Zorro shirt.
What is, like, you mean at, are you over at Crypto Fashion?
No, I'm using Teespring right now.
Oh, I see. Yeah. Andrew is up there vacuuming. Can you hear that? Listen.
No.
You can't hear it?
I can't, no.
Okay, good. She told me that. She's like, I was listening and I heard Ava run across your ceiling, you know? And I was like, oh, I didn't know that. Ebola Jones says, the mask is dumb. And then B-Dad says, it is a little dumb. Don't be soy. And then Gaudia Sertaminus says, yes, Narwhal, the mask is stupid. but other people are saying that you're a goddamn hero. And I think that's important. So, you know, it's up to you. I want Cecil to remove his mask as well. I'm not wearing a hat today, Narwhal.
Yeah, see, that's kind of nice.
I got my little cotton ball of fuzz right in the front. I'm just letting it hang out.
Yeah, it looks good.
Oh, thanks. My brother said, just shave your head. Well, that's what he did. He shaved his head bald. And I said, I don't think so. I'm going to hang on to yesterday.
That's the Jason Statham way. Just kind of buzz it so it's just like an eighth of an inch all around. And you could see that you're balding, but it still looks kind of cool. That depends on the shape of your cranium, though. But it looks like you got a pretty good one.
No, I don't have a watermelon-shaped head. Look at this bump in the back. I got the pack of hot dogs developing. You know what the pack of hot dogs is? That's when you're a fat guy and, like, when you're leaned over or leaned over, like, this all doubles up and it looks like a pack of hot dogs. Antonio, are you still here?
I am still here. Yes, sir.
Oh, okay.
Well, Antonio, do you got a pack of hot dogs?
Yes, he does.
Yeah.
Ballpark. He's like, no, I just got one sausage. One that huge could sausage.
This just could be like, yeah, strength rolls, like rolls of muscle.
Okay. I'll take your word for it.
Yeah. I'm not going to shave it. I'm going to hang on to it. I like it. I like the sides of my hair, you know, but I'm telling you one thing, Narwhal, I'm going gray real quick. Like, look at this. This is Comic Skate. You see this? This is Comic Skate right here. This is old man EVS happening. This is fighting about war campaign. This is fighting with Edwin. This is fighting with people. Fighting with SJWs. It's crazy.
It's like classic being in high school with two of your friends hating each other. And you're navigating the waters well, I think. And I appreciate all the work you do. But yeah. Oh, sorry for nice, the stress. Huh?
Yeah, I'm just trying to be fair, you know.
It's distinguished, though. It's you know, it's like the leader of Fantastic, Mr. Fantastic kind of.
Really? Games.
Yeah.
Could I be Mr. Fantastic? That would be awesome.
Yeah.
Is that a stretch, Antonio?
No, well, that's the thing. If you're Mr. Fantastic. That, right?
No. Well, I mean, as Mr. Fantastic, you can be anything.
Yeah, that's true. No, you can't. Like, he can't change shape. Like, he can, well, I mean, he can change shape, but he can't turn into an airplane. Like, he's not Plastic
Man. But yeah, that's they do play him different than Plastic Man, because I've noticed he can't even really change his face or anything, you know.
No.
But Plastic Man can make himself look like a woman or any other thing. I was like, okay.
Yeah. Let's see. Linkle said, Linkle lets you list all the links to your stuff, says Mr. CPU. James Dean Anderson says, the Rainbow Brute is getting developed now. Now, he's doing it. Here's the thing. James Dean Anderson is he designed the Rainbow the Brute logo. And then somebody said to me in private, I listen to everybody. People send me messages. I'm very easily swayed. Somebody said to me, Rainbow the Brute. It sounds like you're putting a rainbow on a brute. It's a verb. You've made it sound like an action. Let's Rainbow the Brute. Right or wrong?
I don't know. It does. The Rainbow Brute does tend to flow a little better for me, but I mean, that's just my personal opinion.
Did you put the in for like copyright? I missed that.
Yes. Yeah. 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 Like, how can we make it? How can we distance itself? Because I mean, you know, they're going to sue me if it's too close. So it's going to be a pointless lawsuit because it's parody. It's clearly parody. But still, I don't want to spend the money if I don't have to, like defending a frivolous lawsuit. So the Rainbow Brute probably sounds better. The Rainbow Brute. You could do, well, I don't know. The Batman with a, you know, a dash in the middle. If DC Comics loses the copyright to Batman, will or cannot copyright. Let me rephrase this here. I'm all tangled up in my words. Okay, pretty soon, Detective Comics number 27 is going to go to the public domain. All right, that is going to happen, you know, during the next 10 years or so. Actually, no, I think it's 2032. So in the year 2032, DC Comics is going to lose their copyright for that one issue of Batman. So that means that, Antonio, technically, if you wanted to do your own book based on the character and the story within Detective Comics number 27, technically you're allowed to, okay? But you would have to be very, very careful because DC Comics would make sure that there you didn't overstep in any way to kind of reflect the Batman stuff that they still own the copyright to. So you would be sitting there working on Detective Comics number 27. You might be able to call it the Bat-Man,
And yeah, and I've heard about that because I've been watching your boy Zach's videos, and he really made my imagination spark up just from talking about, redoing like John Carter, redoing Batman or something, because they'll be in the public domain. I need to consult my attorney, Jamal Eichel, about this, but I am positive that I can possibly add something to this. Yeah, I'll be very excited about it.
Yeah, I wonder. What do you think of that, Narwhal?
I wonder, is there precedence for this? Like, has something gone into the public domain where it's just the beginning of the IP and then we see new versions of it? I'm trying to think. Like, it's like a spin.
Sherlock Holmes. You can do any Sherlock Holmes book except for the last one. The last one is not in the public domain. I don't know what the last one is because I don't read and I'm illiterate. But if you do read it and you know the Sherlock Holmes books, then you would know that you can do any Sherlock Holmes thing that you want. If you want to do a Sherlock Holmes comic book, you're allowed to. But the stuff that happens in the very last book of Sherlock Holmes, whatever information that they have there, you're not allowed to do that. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
So, when Batman or Detective Comics number 27 goes into the public domain, you are going to, you're going to be able to do anything that's in there. But nothing else.
So you couldn't use like any of the Rogues Gallery that come later?
No. Yeah. I don't know if they mentioned, like, is Gotham City mentioned? I don't know. Like, you would literally be limited to what is in that one 10-page story.
I think Gotham's mentioned. Alfred doesn't exist yet. Mm-hmm. Certain things, there's no Batmobile, any of that kind of thing. You'd be limited to what doesn't, to what existed in that particular issue.
Yeah. You would have to change everything. But it's interesting. It's interesting anyway. I would never dare. You would have to be insane to try to do it. Honestly, Mickey Mouse, Mickey Mouse is going to kind of go into the public domain too. At least Steamboat Willie. The Steamboat Willie version of Mickey Mouse is going to go into the public domain at the same time as Batman. So would you try to do Mickey Mouse?
No. Disney's lawyers are like on another level, man.
They delayed that a few times already, but it's annoying.
They can't do it anymore. There's no more delay. There's no more delay. They have to go ahead and do it. So you could do it. You could, like, if you wanted to, you could do Steamboat Willie. I don't even know if his name's Mickey Mouse yet. But you could do Steamboat Willie potholders. You know what I mean? You could market a product, but you would have to make sure that, it was only Steamboat Willie. Those images, you could pull an image from Steamboat Willie and print that on a potholder and sell it. But you couldn't maybe call it Mickey Mouse, unless it was called Mickey Mouse. I don't know. I'm not sure. But yeah, Disney will definitely kick your ass for it. Or try to, but you would probably win the lawsuit if you were very, very careful.
And rich. Now,
yeah. See, this is the whole thing. So people go, why the Rainbow Brute? Well, because I don't want a frivolous lawsuit. This is clearly parody. Obviously it's parody, but they did the same thing to the Garbage Pail Kids, and that is, that is something to worry about. Let me read some more things here. Let's see. Greg Bowen says, wonder if you checked in on Tug. All right. So that's an important thing. We're going to talk about that in a minute. DJ Kong says, hey, pretty boy, Ethan, are you going to use the new imprint to give us Choose Your Own Adventure comics? DJ Kong's making fun of me here. I have revolutionary ideas and they're not always appreciated in my own time. When I die.
Oh, no.
Which is not going to be for a long time.
Absolutely. Right.
But when I die, people are going to say, Ethan had great ideas. Now, one of the ideas that I had that everyone laughed at, they all laughed, was I said, what about producing a 20-page comic that has four chapters. The first chapter will always be the same, but the last two chapters are different for every book. So it's not Choose Your Own Adventure, but it's like, look, you would be doing, all right, so if it's 20 pages, each chapter is 5 pages, you would have to draw, let's say, 50 extra pages, okay, that represent different outcomes for the story. The third chapter and the fourth chapter would be different for every single book. The story would read differently for everyone. And people said, you're a madman.
is it random, like the same cover, so people buy more that way? Or probably not. That'd be too much of a cash grab.
No. Yeah, it would be the same cover. You would not, everyone's story would end differently. So, you know, in other words, you would have it prepared. You'd say, okay, so chapter one and chapter two are the same, but chapter three and chapter four are going to arc off in a different direction and are going to end that way. And there are maybe two different chapter threes and two different chapter fours that still work together. Like you could alternate them. And so, you know, basically you would have to buy maybe three copies of the book to read all three different versions of the story.
Yeah, collectors would want to get all three of them. And you could maybe do like Easter eggs on the covers to barely notice what version of the ending it is for collectors. Like, so they'll find the discrepancies in the covers. Like there's one little change.
People in the chat are saying, not this shit again. No, it's it's variant story. Instead of variant covers, what about variant interiors, Antonio?
Variant interiors, that would I don't know. It's like, outside of the box. Although I heard you describing your Flash story that you pitched to DC with the, you know, the drop coffee cup and the thing. I actually thought that was brilliant. I know you would have probably been able to pull that, although I'm understand why they probably passed on it, but I thought that was a different take. So
it is brilliant, and I'm going to do it myself. I'm calling it Mean Streak. And it's going to be my Flash. You know how Rob Liefeld did his own Superman, Wonder Woman character?
He just takes everybody's shit.
why not, though? It's like, hey, I'm not going to be telling Wonder Woman stories, but here's my character, Glory, who is just Wonder Woman, but
even white hair. Aaron might be a Dotto to draw her. I was like, that's hilarious.
Here's what, and here's my Superman. His name is Supreme, which basically has all the letters of Superman in it almost. It's Supreme, and Alan Moore is going to come because he's mad at you, and he's going to come tell all of his Superman stories here using my characters. That's genius. So why wouldn't I tell all the Flash stories that I have using my own Speedster character?
What did you say the name was?
Mean Streak.
Rich Johnson
did an article about me called Ethan Van Sciver's Mean Streak Returns, and I went, that'll mean something different when I do my own comic called Mean Streak.
You know? That's good. I like that there's a troll backstory to it, kind of.
There's a troll backstory to everything that I do.
Yeah, see, the Mean Streak is a good idea. The Choose Your Own Adventure is terrible.
Hi, John Malin.
Hi. I came in here to rescue you, Ethan.
Why?
I don't know if you were aware. All of you guys are delusional.
Oh, no.
Because I heard you put out the call for ComicsGate. It's dead.
Oh, right. Yeah.
I have heard that. Yes.
Yeah, they're saying that SJWs are all saying, ha, ComicsGate's dead now. RT Bear is like, I'm getting messages from my friends telling me ComicsGate's dead. Are you guys okay? We're fine, Art. We're fine. ComicsGate is just fine. Truthfully, ComicsGate exists as long as the fans exist. And how many people are watching right now?
Million. A few, right? Two people.
Two's enough.
It's just us.
No, Jesus Christ said, where there are two or three gathered in my name, there I am also. But so that should be good enough. If it's good enough for Jesus, it's good enough for me.
Mm-hmm.
You know what? I actually watched the stream the other day, and the guy was drawing on there. He had two people watching, and I was one of them. And I suspect the other person was him, because you get counted as a viewer for watching you. He was having a full conversation. I was like, hey, brother, no one's going.
I've been in those live streams where I just go in there and they're like they're just 15 people in there, and I'm like, why are we doing this? Why are we doing this?
He streamed for like 3 hours. It was funny as shit. I was like, damn, dude.
I remember when I was first figuring out YouTube, I went live and it would say like one people watching, two people watching. I'd just be like, who are you guys? I'm just testing this. I'm a nobody. It's like lurkers just come out of nowhere to just watch live streams.
Hilarious. Well,
we've got 1,679 people here. We've got John Malin, Antonio Narwhal. Basically, just with us four and that and this crowd, ComicsGate's still alive. If that's all it were, you know.
That's all it is. Oh, just four in the crowd.
Everyone else is left.
Hugh Cares says there was a character in X-Men 2099 called Mean Streak.
Oh, well.
That's okay.
I'm going to find out if it's one word or two words, and I'm going to do the other one.
I got a word for you, a name for you. The Sprinter.
The Sprinter.
or the runner.
Running Man.
What about Ethan? Have you guys ever seen the movie Run Lola Run?
Yeah. Runner Non-Binary.
That could be a comic where there's like five versions and she dies in four of them, and in one of them she survives. So you might want to buy the one that she survives in or something. That's what's your idea, kind of. I know people don't want to talk about that anymore.
People are upset. They're noticing the Mike S. Miller emoji is gone. Yeah, I took the Mike S. Miller emoji down, except for the Hey Mike. That can stay. But the I think is Hey Mike still there? Did I remove that too? I removed that, and I removed Dirtworm Doug. Until those guys are back here, I don't want to troll them. So, you know, I'm hoping Mike S. Miller comes back soon. I know he's nursing hurt feelings, but, you know, we love Mike, and I'm sure that eventually he'll be back. Let me read some more of these real quick, and then we're going to go on to Tug and the abuse that he is suffering today on Twitter. Unhinged Crank says, where's Brand?
Ah, I'm so glad he asked that, because one of the things that keeps going around is that the book is canceled and that Kanan's not on the book anymore. There's all these lies that are being spread. So I'm so glad you asked that. So if you go on the Indiegogo page, you will see the link right there. Like, click on the story, you'll see the link. I have released the first 21 pages of the story with letters and everything. And I have shown on various social media up to page 40 in pencils. We've got inks into the 30s, and I need layouts on 8 more pages. So I put that out. But yeah, it's a scam, man. I'm scamming everybody. That's what it is. But yeah, you can read it.
Darth Gavel says, our Lord Doomcock is the only master of the Hollow Earth. James Dean Anderson is working on that, the Rainbow Brute logo. So we're going to see what that looks like, and I'll make a decision. Mr. CPU says, oh, I read that one. Zerank says, is Man in a Wig another Weird Al parody song? Actually, you know, it sounds like a David Bowie album, like Man in a Wig. Or doesn't it? I don't know. Man in a Wig. Mark C.
says, Alison Chains song.
Oh, yeah. I'm the man in a wig.
Yeah.
I'm the man in a Party City wig. Yeah, that'd be good. Mark C. says, Narwhal reminds me of Butters' Professor Chaos from South Park.
I'll take that.
Peter, you will? Peter Armstrong says, I set up another YouTube account just so I can send you super chats. I don't know why I'm blocked from sending them to you with my main account. I don't know, Peter Armstrong. I've had some interesting people that were running my what do you call them when you're in the chat and you
moderate
my mods? Yeah. There's some people who, there are a few people who I've banned personally, but not you, I don't think. And I've had some disgruntled mods. Unhinged Crank says, that's called Sharpay Head, Ethan. That's when you have the hot dog pack in the back. Rastock says, would a new edition rainbow theme be affordable? New edition rainbow theme be affordable? What does that mean?
Does he mean the band new edition?
That's what I was thinking.
I was like, oh man, if we can get you on the piano and whipping something up, I'll be all right with that.
Mr. Telephone Man.
I was like, I don't know. They've got so many hits. I was like,
they have a lot of hits. They were popular in their day. Hold on, let me turn off my camera, and I'm gonna see if I can play a little Mr. Telephone Man for you.
Oh man, I love it. I'm excited.
Let's see here.
Oh yeah. Ooh.
Was that good?
Yeah, man.
Yeah. That wasn't good.
I need some flame emojis in the chat though. I need them. Fire them up, baby. Let them know.
Yeah. All right. Moving on. Charlie, we didn't answer that guy's question at all. Charlie's London says, my husband creates spray paint art. He did one online and received a cease and desist from Disney in 48 hours. The House of Mouse is Big Brother, LOL. Pilgrim Driver says, when is Cyberfrog shipping? Well, Cyberfrog Vampirella is already shipping. Everybody has it. I think they're getting it. You didn't get yours yet?
Not yet, but I mean, you know, I've got the three covers signed.
Okay.
Well, no, it hadn't came yet. I've been checking, but I'm waiting on it.
I did all the signings already, so they should be, everything should be on their way. But I know they're probably shipping them out in order of, they're probably going for the just regular ones first, and then they'll do the signed ones or something. I don't know. Pilgrim Driver says, so when is Cyberfrog shipping? Soon. When I get the books, I printed 12,000 copies of the Cyberfrog Chromium, 3,000 copies of the Salamandroid Chromium, if that tells you anything. So there are going to be 12,000 Cyberfrog Chromiums and 3,000 Salamandroid Chromiums. Those are going to be scarce. I don't care how much you hate me. Do not cancel or refund your Salamandroid cover. It is going to be worth many, many, many times what you paid for it. And you will be silly. Sell it on eBay. And then I'm printing probably something like 10,000 of the team up covers. Mm. And we'll see. You know, right now, I think I've sold about 5,000 of them. So I'll print 10,000 and we'll just have them to be ready. Septonov 7 of 9 says, I wrapped my Wi-Fi router in tinfoil, put it on the roof, and pointed it towards New Jersey. The password is Thundercroak. Thank you so much.
Nice.
You know, I need a little bit of that. Save Overby says, what happened to Mike S. Miller emoji? We answered that. Mark C. says, I think your variant storytelling is interesting, but I think it only works if you do one chapter one, two chapter two, four chapter three, and eight chapter four. That's interesting. I wouldn't know how to do it. I would have to figure it out. Track Media only says, Rainbow the Brute has the same flow as Conan the Barbarian. Sounds better, seems to fit what you said. Though I liked Rainbow the Brute better. So did Zach. Zach likes taking Bro. He says you should own Bro, you know, and then so you have Bro White, and everything should have Bro in it because it is toxic masculinity. You know, Bro is toxic, isn't it? That's and all the stupid feminists are like, hey, dude, Bro.
When you put it that way, it sounds like a good idea. Double pun too, like Rain, R-E-I-G-H-N or whatever.
Bro. Yeah. All right. So, James Dean Anderson, try Rain Bro the Brute instead of the Rainbow Brute. Rain Bro the Brute. Well, that's what Zach says. Like, I don't know. I just want to call it Rainbow Brute, but apparently everyone's afraid of that, and you know, I'm a little bit of afraid. Well, I'm being made to be afraid of it. You know, that's the thing. I wouldn't be afraid of it if people didn't make me afraid. Michael Ross says, will you be doing the rest of Vampirella versus the Reanimator series, Uncle? I love the cover in the book. Yeah, I'm sitting here. I'm working on a Vampirella. Can you see me, by the way? Oh, I turned the camera off. Okay, hold on a second. Let me turn that back on. I'm just working on a Vampirella cover now. As you can see, she's like, biggie, biggie, biggie. Can't you see? Sometimes you
just hypnotize me.
Yeah. I'm working on a little Vampy piece today that's going to be the cover of Vampy 1, and then we're going to be doing, oh, Cyberfrog's in it. By the way, it's going to be filthy. I don't know if you can see, John, I never show you my sketches because my blue line stuff sucks, but she's riding the thorax of a dead Vespis, and ooh, she's pulling his stinger up between her legs.
Oh. That's like a that's like a satanic music video. And that's awesome. Possibly a good thing.
It's a little porno-based. It's a, nice. It's going to look a little porno. Okay, she's got that stinger and she's like pulling it up between her legs and she's riding it. Like,
yeah, I didn't think it, but now you said it, now I see it.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So that's going to be my Vampy cover. Cyberfrog's going to be in the background. People said, well, how about if you have her kissing Cyberfrog? I don't want that. Like, it's too cutesy. Like, it's so soy-based. Like, if I gave my Cyberfrog, if I hired Tumblr to do Cyberfrog Vampirella cover, that's what they would do. Cyberfrog would be like, oh, shucks, as Vampy was smooching him on the cheek. It would be like,
Ethan, this cover is going to be called the Vampirella pegging cover.
Oh, yeah. That's what it is. Well, is she pegging? Yeah, I guess kind of. There is no recipient of the peg. Let me point that out. And by the way, you would, even if you like pegging, you would not want to be the recipient of this peg.
That's a peg from that movie Seven with Brad Pitt.
Yeah. Yeah.
Ugh. Oh, sexy party. This makes me uncomfortable.
It's like, I'm into Biggie Smalls lately, though.
Yeah. I'm digging your taste in Muzak.
It's old hip hop. Like, I'm listening to old hip hop all the time. It makes me happy. And people can say, hey, stop it all they want, but I won't stop it. I like it.
But you always surprise me. Yeah, you always surprise me with your different choices. I was like, when you switch the intro music up, and I'll be like, wait a minute. Mm-hmm.
As I proceed to give you what you need, let's go on to Kay Brady says, James, no, there's a lot more that I have to read. Hold on a second. I'm sorry. So, yes, I will be doing the rest of the Vampy Reanimator series because it makes SJWs crazy. By the way, we had, what's his name, that fat dude, Scott Kurtz, in the chat the other day. And he was like, Ethan, in your unasked for, unwanted Vampirella cover. Like, that was crazy. I'm like, no, dude, factually, it was wanted. It raised nearly $70,000. You know, it's like, that means, like, I can prove that. You know, it's like, that's a provable thing that it was wanted.
You bought them yourself.
I what?
You bought them yourself.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. Oh, you bought them yourself. Yeah. You just wanted to buy your way into the... Do I look like somebody who needs to beg for anything? Do I look like somebody that's asking anyone for favors at this point in my career? Mm-mm. No, people are asking me for favors.
I am the one who knocks.
That's right. Okay, so Rodin says, the Rainbow Brute is better than Rainbow the Brute. The Rainbow Brute. No, the Rainbow Brute. Okay. See, there are a million different versions of this. Brassock says, does Shiro sleep with a Cyberfolk plushie? Maybe he does. Shiro Pocket. That's Rainbow Brute's, you know, effeminate son. James Dean. Well, Rainbow Brute, like, knocked up a Polly Pocket.
That is so funny.
And the Polly Pockets are good because the only posability they have is they bend at the waist, John.
I know they bend, though.
They how do you bend. Know this?
Well, I mean, that's, you know, I grew up with four sisters, so I've seen all these toys. Okay.
Is she a character in the book? Because she could be a good character.
She is mentioned in the book. She is mom. Like, now Polly Pocket. Here's the thing. When Rainbow Brute met Polly Pocket, and she does just, I mean, that there's only one hinge, okay, on a Polly Pocket. Here's a Polly Pocket. They go, bam, and bend right over, right? So that's why Polly Pockets are whores. And Rainbow Brute, like, met one of them. He met Polly Pocket, had a one-night stand with her, as you do when you're a barbarian, knocked her up, and the result is Shiro Pocket. And Shiro Pocket was raised by all the women of the Polly Pocket world. There are no men in Polly Pocket's world. If you had a Polly Pocket set when you were a little girl, Antonio, you would notice that there were no men. It was just women. So Shiro is raised by women.
Classic.
Yeah, he's a little bit of a sissy. A little bit of a sissy.
Is he also prone to that one pose?
Yeah.
He's one of those like chickens that dips in the water, you know?
He's inherited it. I mean, that's right. So Shiro Pocket is now, we want to make him Shiro Brute. You know, that's ultimately our goal. You know, he should have his father's last name, but Polly Pocket hates Rainbow Brute. Like, she's mad at him for abandoning her and leaving her with this kid. So Rainbow Brute's going to take him out, teach him how to be a man. You know, there's some things only a father can teach you, and that's what this book is about. And then at the end of the book, you want to see if Shiro Pocket becomes Shiro Brute.
Yeah, that sounds good. You got, like, the emotional arc and the plot arc you mentioned in a previous stream sounded good. It's like saving his brother or something like that, or sister, I forget.
Yeah. Saving his aunt, then. Shiro Pocket's aunt. You know.
Is she named Kant? Is that her name? Is the aunt named Kant?
Aunt Kant?
Yeah, Aunt Kant.
The new God of War video game could be good inspiration, Ethan. You should watch a Let's Play of that. You could spoof a lot of that, probably.
Yes. The book's going to be so good. If only I could write. Well, we'll see what you guys think of how I write. You know, you're going to read Cyberfrog Blood Honey. Yes. Of course, in case you haven't seen it yet. This is Cyberfrog Blood Honey. This is the proof copy. A lot of people are hitting me up trying to buy these off of me. They're like, you don't have to. I mean, of course I'll send you one for free. Antonio, I wouldn't, would I? I wouldn't do that. That would be wrong.
Well, I would like one, but you've done so much for me. I've been embarrassed to ask you for anything.
Well, I would like you to read this proof copy. By the way, proof copy, it doesn't mean because this is just a proof. It means this is proof that it's done, you mother effers. Here it is. You know, I mean, book. It's THICC.
It's the suck it copy.
Yes.
Well, yeah, I was jealous. I was talking to Zach, and he told me that you let him read Cyberfrog, and I was like, he didn't let me read Cyberfrog.
No, you know, he hates Cyberfrog. He's like, why is he a little monster? He's a little monster. I'm like,
yeah, he roasts it kind of hard. It's pretty funny.
He's like, he's not a monster. I don't know why Zach can't deal with like these kind of characters, but everybody has to be a G.I. Joe to him. I mean, look, I actually wrote this for Zach. Like, he's like, they think I'm a monster. And Heather's like, you aren't a monster. You know, it's like, that's important. You know, that's for Zach. Heather is saying Zach is wrong. Don't listen to Zach.
I'm glad you and him are friends, because he doesn't like Cyberfrog. He doesn't like your voice. He doesn't watch your videos.
I think he loves my videos, by the way.
That's one thing that's changed.
Like, he's like, I've listened to that one video of yours 3 times. I'm like, what's the matter with you? That's a 3-hour video. He's like, I'm busy on the road, you know? So now he's into my videos. He likes the things that I have to say. And like, he hit me up. He's like, you know, he's like, here's the thing about you. You're a dumb Jersey lunkhead, but he said, you had this one idea that was so brilliant that I wish I had thought of it myself. And I was like, well, what is that? And he goes, when you said that comic book company, like cat spankers are dead, it doesn't make any sense why we're still following this model. Because when you put out the first 20, let's say that a story is 6 issues long, therefore it's 120 pages long that you've paid the same amount of money for as a publisher. These guys are putting out the first 20 pages as a number one issue that sells 80,000 copies. And then issue 2 drops down to 30,000 copies. And then the rest of it just continues to sink downhill. Why are we still following that model instead of putting out the whole 120 pages at once out there for $25? And then it all sells as though it were a number one issue. You've been reading every single page. What?
Binge reading, like Netflix is binge watching.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So he's like, why, you know, just from a financial, like that is where it's going, like Netflix, you know, and everything. And he's like, I can't believe it's so stupid and so brilliant. Like, he's like, I'm mad at myself for not thinking of it. And I said, yeah. And here's the thing, like no more cluttering up the shelves of retailers. And also for us, people are like, it would be great if you could just get your comics to be $3. It's like, why would we ship $3 comic? Like, it's so hard to fulfill these campaigns. Like, it really is a big effort to fulfill a campaign by hand. It's like, imagine if we broke down our comics into $3 portions and then had to do fulfillment 4 or 5 times a year. I mean, it's not workable. But if we just did bigger books that, you know, and charged $25 for them, then we'd only have to ship them out once a year. It would be doable and people would be getting the same amount of story. So I might be a Jersey lunkhead, but there's a little bit of brain in that lunk. Little bit.
There you go.
John, am I wrong? Am I deluding myself?
No, I agree 100%. I think the $3 model would be nearly impossible for what we're doing. Yeah. Maybe there's some way around it. But right now, I'm not that imaginative.
Yeah. All right. So what I wanted to, I'm going to take a break from Super Chats. I want to talk about poor Umbrella Guy, and he's under some pressure right now.
He's in the chat.
Oh, he's in it. Oh, cool. Hey, Tug, enjoy this. So there are weirdos who are harassing that Umbrella Guy. These SJWs. Oh, Cecil, hi.
Hello.
Hey,
Cecil.
All right.
What happened to the old Cecil? Where you've become your real self lately?
The hell are you talking about?
Hi. You used to come in and be like, "Hello."
I'm in an office right now.
Yeah, you got a job.
There are other people. Problem. There are
Quit
other
your job.
I'm trying.
Get fired.
There are other people here, so I keep my hellos down a little bit. Sorry.
All right. So I want to show you this. Let's go through this together. I want to show you the people who are harassing that Umbrella Guy. And he has, first of all, Umbrella Guy is the target of some of the worst SJWs in the world. Now, I have been patient and kind with these SJWs like Renfamous. She knows that I have not unloaded both barrels at her.
Unloaded.
Yeah. not at her, maybe about her, not at her. Oh, I shouldn't have said that. I haven't done that. I've been kind and gracious to you, you weirdo, you stuttering weirdo. I've been kind and gracious to you. But that is going to come to an end very, very soon if you do not call off your dogs at my friend Tug, who's done nothing wrong. Donald DeLay, welcome. Now, here, why do you guys not fill in the space when I leave the air silent like that?
Ethan, you just told me about four streams ago that's your new thing, is you want the message
to end. Yeah, that is true. Thank you, John, for keeping me honest. All right, so here's an example of the torment that Umbrella Guy is receiving, and some of it that he's not receiving that is aimed at him. This person says, by the way, nice goddamn, this is degeneracy of the highest order. When are they going to stop this?
Furry.
You know what I mean? This, the furry emoji or the furry avatars. Deep down inside, I'm a cute fox. Deep down inside, I'm a sexy fox. And I'm purple. Ooh. Ew.
Sexy fox. Antonio's down.
Yeah.
DTF.
Oh, man. Hilarious.
As you can see, by the way, at my screen, I am following that Umbrella Guy. I am not following Cynical Vixen, but maybe I will at the end of this. I thought long and hard before posting this, but this is the caliber of the Brains Trust currently harassing that Umbrella. But they check their facts, right? They have receipts and right on their side. I blurred the handle and name, but you don't have to be Sherlock Holmes. This guy goes, I boasting about having receipts to show that Tug. Okay, so this is at Tug, T-U-G, that they blurred out. AKA Matt Lewis and his buddy at Yellow Flash are liars and cowards. And Matt and his wife have a pattern of doxing themselves whenever they need money and attention at the expense of other people who are innocent of their false accusations. Now, this is a bold statement here. This is, you know, by the way, can you see this or can you not see it?
Yeah, yeah.
I can see it.
Green shirt? Okay. And then this person, he's doing at Tug. Okay. It's like, that's not the Umbrella Guy's. Here's the joke of this. At Tug is not the Umbrella Guy. It's just some guy named Tug. So he's like, hey, I'm not Matt Lewis. Please delete this tweet before I report you to Twitter. Okay. Now you would think that would be it, but it isn't it. So here we go again. How about at Tug put his own family into danger by doxing himself while those who falsely accused are on record saying that they don't have and spread his info that he revealed himself. He can't play the victim while he victimizes other people to sucker all of you. John Wilkes. I've asked you politely to I'm sorry, I'm going to lose it. I've asked you politely to cease this.
Oh, poor guy.
I've asked you politely to cease this abuse. I will ask you politely again. Next time I'll ask Twitter to suspend your account. Looks like someone created a fake Twitter account.
Where
is your supposed abuse when the truth has been exposed? I got to stop laughing. I got to be able to deliver this. Other people are supposed to laugh. I'm supposed to deliver this properly. Like Orson Welles' spirit come into me now. Looks like someone created a fake Twitter account. Where is your supposed abuse when the truth has been exposed? I can involve the feds with one text or email to a family friend. You need to stop the nonsense and con. This guy goes, check the profile. This account has been in existence for 12 years. I'm getting tired of this nonsense. His name is Tug.
Oh, no.
No, his name is John, but I know him. He's a tugboat captain
out here. Is that right?
Yeah. A tugboat captain.
I'm going to die. I'm seriously going to die. 411, that Umbrella Guy goes under the name of at Tug, and that's how most people address him on YouTube. So if I were you, I would ignore it and change my at Tug to something else. Now he wants this guy to change his Twitter handle, okay, or his Twitter account, because he just wants to throw abuse at Pug.
Yeah,
that's convenient. It's his for fault. Him.
It's his fault. Should have thought of this 12 years ago. Asshole.
Instead of just figuring out, he's like, why don't you contact that umbrella? You know it, so you do know. You do know his Twitter handle. And tell him to stop using your @ since you had it for longer than he. So this must be very confusing. This guy's going, who is, what, that umbrella guy, what, okay, so let's find out what he says here. Let's get rid of this. God, this is the greatest thing I've ever seen. I just got an abusive tweet from some random US guy. He obviously got my tag wrong. I politely pointed out I wasn't who he thought he was. He accused me of setting up a fake account. I pointed out that this account has been here for more than 12 years. He got abusive again. Obviously a virgin. Okay. When an old man like that is telling you that you're a virgin. All right. So super smart. He goes, more stupid is believing that someone drove by and used a bat on it, which is impossible because there three is no damage to the green metal sign holder along with zero footprints and tire marks. A duct tape mailbox that someone did a drive-by to knock it down. Unless that car and the person with the bat could vibrate through the green metal sign holder to knock it over, then I would believe that dumb fella guy or Matt the Mooch. I see. He's got some nicknames here. Matt broke his own mailbox where his picks destroyed his case because based on where the broken box was located and no damage and debris to the green metal sign holder. This person, well, this rather attractive young lady says, citation needed. Why would a citation be needed when the pick? Looks like you easily believe a liar without looking at the pick. I'm dying. What? Okay, she goes, cope harder. How about going to Dominic Skies or Tug's page for picks? You're the one who needs to cope and accept the fact that those picks show he is a liar. Where a blind person can see his charm does not, his claim does not add up. This is fantastic. So poor umbrella guy has to deal with this. But not only that, oh my God, he comes back. Who says that I flag videos? Pulling a hat top. I dragged into it again. Oh my God, he's like, just when I thought I was a fucking nightmare for this guy. I've got a friend at Tug. I gotta find this guy and just be his friend. I mean, his taste of these SJW weirdos, just a sample of SJW weirdos that come into his life, he just gets to taste what that umbrella guy goes through every single day, and he writes it off as virginity, which is a good guess. Pulling a at Tug, where you and your buddies flag and report them yourselves to get money and attention to fit your victim narrative. We know your games and have receipts, but we don't cyberstalk like you and at Tug. He hit him twice and the same thing. Oh my God. Oh my God.
He has such great investigative skills, but he can't stop adding that guy.
No, he can't.
The Indian so PI.
It's like Memento. He's like going backwards. He forgets it every 5 minutes.
Every 5 minutes. And poor umbrella guy has to apologize. He goes, at Tug. He goes, I apologize, sir. They're trying to harass me. I was recently doxxed, private info made public, family photos and more shared, and we had property damage afterwards. People call me Tug, shortening that umbrella guy, so it's attacking random people. Again, sorry idiots did that. Poor Tug. I got to like this. And, you know, I don't need to retweet it because it'd be out of context, but I have to like it.
What about the other Tug?
Yeah, did he respond again?
What about John Wilson? Why, he didn't get a like.
No, he didn't get a like. Hold on a second. Let's see. Tug, Tugboat McPuppy. No, just Tug. I wouldn't be surprised if that guy blocked his. Look at this. Hi, why are you abusing a random person? Hold on a second. There he is. Look at him. He didn't do anything wrong.
Oh, he's a geek. Look.
Is he a geek? One of us. Oh, he is. Skeptic, geek, photographer, printer. He's in the UK. He's got some lunatic. Oh, Sweetcast is following him now. I get to it. All right, everyone follow John Wilson at Tug. He deserves a total follower boost here.
And be very kind with John Wilson.
Nice to him. Obviously, do not harass this guy. Only give him praise for being exposed to complete and total assholery.
Ethan, did you see Twitter was suggesting follows for you? They're all the follows with Tug in it. So it's like Tuggy McTuggerson.
Here's his tweet. I got to see this. All right, there's Umbrella Guy responding. Geez, sorry to hear this. All of his friends are just like, clearly, why is it that social media seems not to bring the worst in some people? Obviously got nothing better to worry about. Thinking about giving it up, better things to do. Zach would give this guy a high five. That is the, all right. So
I just subbed Tug.
Oh, good, good. He says, I've had countless people wanting the at Tug Twitter handle, some politely, some with threats. This guy was abusing somebody who was Tug somewhere else and couldn't grasp that different people can have the same handle on different platforms. It's not just that, John. That's not the situation. The situation is his nickname is Tug, and so he assumed that anyone who just puts at Tug would lead to Matt Lewis, aka that Umbrella Guy. That did not work. That was not the case. And this guy comes in and lets him know. Can you imagine what a strange twilight zone of a world we live in right now? These weird SJWs. And they used to come, it used to be about me. It used to be, first it was Zach. Zach fled social media. And then it was me. And I stayed, but I don't know, man. I don't get much pushback from them anymore.
From like Ren and Tim and those guys? Because you started to ignore them. You started to ignore them.
It's just ignoring them.
Yeah, they go on to somebody who will give them play.
Is that what's going on here? Like, what if Fat Umbrella Guy just immediately cut them all off?
Then
would that make a difference?
Probably.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, they're getting action. They're getting.
Michael says I'm sad about it. Yeah. They just want to play around. I think.
They don't have anything going on. They're like just looking for people to fight with.
Yeah.
And for Ren and them, I mean, anime is a much bigger market. They never cared about comics. So,
I think some people pointed Ren my way. Like, hey, I want to get involved with Comicsgate. I want to harass people. And initially, she was harassing Zach, and then Zach kind of left, and they said, no, you want to harass Ethan Van Sciver. And I think that's how it went. And I kind of liked sparring with Renfamous. I made her cry and block me a couple of times. And I kind of enjoyed her. And then when she came out and did that video all about me, that live stream, and she was a stuttering fat mess, and we all laughed at her, I think that changed everything. She decided to move on to Tug. So I'm sorry, that Umbrella Guy. I'm not sorry at Tug. I'm sorry at Tug too, but you're not receiving the abuse that he is. You just got a nice sample of it. Poor Tug. K Brady says, I bought a bunch of copies of Salamandroid so I can sell on eBay. Thanks for next summer's vacation. Good for you. James Dean Anderson says, logo naming options on Ethan's Twitter. Go vote. Yeah, like what should it be? Razdoc says, no, a bro is a him bro. Is it? Chappie says, as a fan of The Flash, I support this idea. You do it better anyway. Track Media only says, I totally want that cover. Here's a 10 to show my conviction. White Wolf says, EVS, do a hyper-masculine parody of He-Man. He-Bro. What do you think of He-Bro?
He-Bro. Ethan, couldn't you just use Rainbow Brute and then put something behind it, like a Z or an X or some numbers? Wouldn't that make
How about if you'd call it The Reign of Bro Brute?
But we're getting kind of far away from Rainbow Bright, though. That's the problem. People want to know. People want to look at it and say, oh, yeah, it's a parody of Rainbow Bright, of course. That's the thing. Or you could call it anything. I don't know. I'm not really sure. Let's see. Will we ever get details on the dog betrayal? You mean the Doug betrayal, Super Sandwich. You want to talk about the Doug betrayal for these people? We got 1,862 people watching. Doug's like, it's private. It's private. People who actually did something wrong are like, it's private. It's private. You know. What do you think, Cecil?
His shit talking you doesn't seem private.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm not a big fan of Doug these days. I think he's full of shit. And let's see. Yeah, he was. Listen, we went back and looked at his first few, like within 20 days, he was talking about how he was going to use Comicsgate and leave. And we didn't pay attention to him. He was actually saying who he was, and we ignored it. But the truth is,
we keep saying we.
Well, not me. I kind of knew. I kind of. In fact, in one of those videos, he was like, "I'm tired of getting shit from Cecil." It's kind of because I kind of called him out on it. You know, and started calling him smugless and all that shit. And he didn't like that. Like, he laughed along, but I guess deep down he always fucking hated it. So,
yeah, that's
yeah, what he, I said. He's an opportunist. I don't really, I mean, I admire the hustle on some level. Like, he came in, he fucking made his money, and he fucking left. Like, but Don't cry about, like, you know, people not liking you afterwards. You fucking, you know, stepped on a lot of toes. There was no reason for him to shit on the fuck on Comicsgate on the way out. No, I think he did a tremendous amount of damage. Yeah, he did a lot of damage to Comicsgate while he was here. A lot.
What kind of damage did he do to Comicsgate while he was here?
I think he's been sowing seeds the whole time, trying to break it, fraction it. The whole time. I could just see it with different people. He sectioned different people off. A lot of the sectioning and clicking, that's him. Like, he's in every click, and he's done that kind of, he's done that. I've watched him do it. And I watch him going straight to Nick Rakita, and now he's like, oh, I just had a meeting with Vic Mignogna. And like, this is a guy who was on stream calling him a creep and a weirdo, and now he's having meetings with him. He's seen another fucking a community or business to exploit, and he's going to do it. Like I said, on a business level, hats off to him. But on a personal level, as a friend or a good person, fuck him. I don't like him.
Well, there you have it. Yeah, Cecil sussed him out right away. You know, I was looking back at Doug, and you know, I was worried about Doug. It's funny, like, I forgot why I behaved the way I did. Like, when you pointed out that clip where Doug is just telling people, if this is what Comicsgate is, then and people are going to refund me, then I'm out. And I was just like, well, you know, at the time I was thinking, what are you, nuts? Like, Doug, I know your finances. You need to settle down, you know? And so I should have just, at the time, I should have just been like, get the fuck out then. You don't talk to customers that way. And Comicsgate is exactly what you're saying it is. It's people that, you know, are expecting you to behave a certain way towards them. And if you don't like that, leave. But instead, I was sitting there thinking, fuck, I got to help Doug. I don't know why I'm like that. I got to stop being like that. You know?
No mercy.
Yeah, just be like, if you come out against the customers like that, get the fuck out. Like, get out. But that whole speech, like, now watching it now is sickening.
Yeah, he needed a boot in the ass then, to be honest.
The entitlement.
Yeah.
Of it all, you know. The entitlement of saying, you know, look, I'm harassing Mike S. Miller, making him cry so fans don't like what they're seeing. So they're refunding Bigfoot Bill. And then you're yelling at them and calling them SJWs. So even more of them refund you. And then you sit there and you give them a big speech telling them that if this is what Comicsgate is, you're out. You know,
also, angry. Comicsgate was only 4 or 5% or something. Most of it is his crowd that he's been carrying around for years. That's really the bulk of it.
Where were they? Where were they when you came here looking for help? Where were your fans? That, you know, it's like if you're carrying around so many fans, why couldn't you just do this by yourself? Why did I have to get involved? What was I for? You know, what do I know? And so, yeah. You guys are nothing really. You amount to about $10,000 of what I raised. I did the metrics. So in other words, you're not that important and I don't have to listen to you. And that was all in one little lecture. And the whole time I was thinking, this guy's nuts. But, you know, again, it's like I put up with it and just go, yeah, you know, this guy's got to – I got to give him have a talk with him, get him to straighten up, settle down, you know, or else his book is going to fail, rather than just saying get the fuck out, you know, which is what I should do. Live and learn, you know. But on his way out, so Bigfoot Bill was closing. He said, I'm dedicating the book to you. And I was like, oh, that's really nice. Thank you. And then he said, I won't be using the Comicsgate hashtag anymore, Ethan. And I said, well, why not? He said, because Earthworm Jim, you know, he said, I just won't. Oh, no. He said, I just won't. It's too hot. It's too spicy. Now, before this, he said he told me that he was going to get Earthworm Jim. And it was a simple business transaction. It was Doug saying, Doug was negotiating because they had this new Earthworm Jim video game coming out. So he was going to be due some royalties. So all he really had to do was say, I'm going to trade you my royalties for video games in perpetuity in exchange for the rights to do Earthworm Jim as a graphic novel. It's an even trade that you're either going to take or you're not. It had nothing to do with, you know, oh, you can't be associated with, you know, radical groups, or you can't be saying radical things. Because even then, he was saying kind of radical things about, you know, the Rainbow, SJW Rainbow Coalition, which we all know means gays. So it wasn't a question of I need to watch what I say or who I associate with. Indeed, he's associating with, you know, people who the SJWs in Hollywood would consider to be radicals. Now, I'm someone who doesn't really care what you believe. You can believe whatever you want, but be consistent in that. And by the way, when you're a part of Comicsgate, keep it to yourself. You know, that's kind of the thing. Keep it to yourself. Be consistent in your views. Don't just speak to the people who are in the room right in front of you that you need to appease. But then at the same time, when you're Comicsgate, shut your mouth, please, because we're trying to market to everyone. And we don't want to be associated with those kind of views. We want to be associated with just selling comic books, being positive, being excited, fighting the SJWs who are ruining the comic book industry. But that's just SJWism. It has nothing to do with gay or straight or black or white or trans or, you know, what's the opposite of trans? You know, so, I mean, that's not, you know, that isn't, you know, that isn't our thing. So in any case, you know, I told him on his way out, I said, Doug, that's fine if you don't want to use the hashtag. I'm asking you as a favor to me to just don't run the name Comicsgate down, because it means a lot to me. You know, it's my whole purpose. I wake up in the morning and I think about Comicsgate, and I think about, you know, what I can do next with Comicsgate. So, you know, you comic like leaving Comicsgate is going to be a big deal. Just don't say anything bad about it, please. You know, and he's like, I won't. It's been good to me. I won't. I said, thank you. That's all I ask. And, you know, we can part ways. So don't talk shit. I won't talk shit. It'll be fine. Cecil, how long did it take for him to start calling us anti-Christian?
Immediately. It's like that. And that's what set me off. That's when he was like, he said, Comicsgate is an anti-Christian SJW rainbow movement. That was the exact quote.
So we're pro-gay. We're anti-Christian. Do you know how many of our fans are Christians? Like, a lot of Christians are in here, including me, including most of you.
No, he's a super Christian. He gets to judge all. Don't you know?
So I start getting refunds from people saying I can't associate myself with someone who is anti-Christian, who hates my views. And I'm like, what is this all about? Like, what are you talking about? I don't hate your views. I'm not anti-Christian. I'm Christian. And it's Doug on Twitter. And he has begun to call Comicsgate anti-Christian. And then he started the whole war campaign thing. Ethan knows about war campaign. Ethan is using war campaign to abuse people. So what happens when you say that? War campaign goes after him. That's pretty much what happens. War campaign starts memeing on him, calling him dirtworm, et cetera, which is exactly what he wanted. You know, he wanted that demonstration publicly. So good job, war campaign guys. Then he goes to San Diego Comic-Con on a crowdfunding panel, which, by the way, we were talking right before that. And he says, he's just like, yeah, you know, I'm really afraid that they're going to beat me up with baseball bats and stuff when I go in there. You know, he's like, I know the Rainbow Coalition is going to be waiting there to beat me up. So he shows up with rainbow colored hair and he sits on the panel and starts thanking everybody in the room, including people on that dais who specifically said, I don't want to sit there with him. Who specifically said, we don't want to be a part of this panel if he's on it because he's Comicsgate. And he's sitting there thanking them and telling them that, you know, thank you for all of the, you know, help that you've given me to learn how to crowdfund. And he doesn't even mention my name. He doesn't say Comicsgate. He doesn't mention my name. That would have been the opportunity to do it, to, you know, to sort of repay you guys, repay me, you know, repay everyone in the audience for what we gave him, the boost that he needed at the right time. He doesn't need us anymore. So he doesn't mention Comicsgate. And I decide to go ahead and tweet out, that's weird. I watched the video and I didn't get a shout out or a thank you from Doug that whole time for everything I did for him. Doug hits me up with a message in private immediately. Don't ever fucking do that again, pretty much. You put a hit out on me on Twitter. You put a hit out on me on Twitter by putting that tweet out there, threatening me. I said, Doug, it wasn't a hit. I just, you know, why wouldn't you thank me? And by the way, he's like, if there's anything that you need to say to me, you can say it in private. And I was like, but you're calling me anti-Christian publicly without asking me anything.
That's what are you doing?
That's a real hit. That actually cost me some money. And so we went on and had a long conversation. Like literally, I was just on, you know, back and forth for like 2 hours. And we left it resolved. You know, I mean, we left it. We kind of walked away and just kind of said, he said, you're cool with me. The next day he blocks me on Twitter. And then begins a full scale assault on me and on Comicsgate. Full scale assault.
Yeah, and that's a shame because it's not just hurting you or any of us. It's also the smaller campaigns that are out there trying to make their way that have nothing to do with Doug or, you know, indirect to us as well.
Yeah, there's a lot of opportunity, you know, that we provide for smaller creators that, you know, when you say stuff like that, it scares backers away. You know, it scares customers away. And so these guys are, you know, I mean, look, my campaign's going to go anyway. I'm pretty sure that I have enough subscribers and enough interested parties that I don't need to be Comicsgate. I can just be like, hey, it's me, Ethan, and do really well with Rainbow Brew or Cyberfrog Wrecked Planet. But that doesn't feel that great. What feels really good is sharing that with other people, sharing that platform with other people and letting them get their books funded. And that, again, means everything to me. Comicsgate is my means by which to do that. It's a label that everybody knows. It selects the bravest of creators out there and brings them to me, brings them to John, brings them to our movement and helps them get funded. So I don't want it run down. And I especially don't want it run down by people who benefited so much from it, who took so much from it.
We're going to get more and more clout too as more and more projects and creators come. So like, yeah, long live Comicsgate, guys. And I love you guys all. I got to go. I'm going to go see Once Upon a Time in Hollywood.
Enjoy that. Yeah, I wish I could go see that.
Hey, I want to show you this too. This what are these called? Clipboards. If you carry these outdoors, people are scared that you're going to ask them to like sign a petition or something. But if you're carrying them indoors, then they think you're the boss and like you're checking if things are up to code. I used to carry one around when I worked at a hotel. Everyone thought I was the boss.
You going to take that to the movie theater?
Yeah, I'm going to try and get him for free. All right, I'll see you guys later.
Keep the mask on.
So, yeah, so now Doug has a full-scale campaign against me saying Ethan knew that War Campaign was harassing Sashi and all these people. You know. And what the only thing I said in return to that, like I've been kind of quiet about it and just, you know, Doug says this is between two men, this is private, but you know, on Twitter, he's going full blast at me. The only thing I said was, how come you're erasing all of your transphobia tweets? How come you are actively, people are catching you? All of the things that you said about, you know, transphobia, trans people and gay people, the Rainbow Coalition movement and all that. How come you're deleting those now? That's weird.
Yeah.
And he got really angry at that too. So I don't know. That's why I said, just be consistent with your views. I'm not, you know, I'm no SJW. If that's what you feel like, if that's what you believe, that's fine. But, you know, don't run from those views just because it's inconvenient all of a sudden or because you're trying to con the next person in the room. If you're trying to con the next person in the room that you don't hold those views, you know, I don't have too much respect for that. You know, I don't think that's that great.
That's what he's doing. He's cleaning up his act before he goes over to Weeb Wars.
Yeah, Weeb Wars or anything else like Hollywood, you know, getting back on TV again, VeggieTales, something like that, you know. All right, hold on. Let me get back to this. So what do you think of that, Cecil? Is that fair, or what I just said, or am I wrong in any way?
No, I think it's completely fair. He had an opportunity to, if he wanted to leave Comicsgate, fine. But you go, hey, this was a great, a great experience for me. I made a lot of new fans and new friends, but I'm going to have to move on and blah, blah, blah. That's not what he did. That's not what he did. He wanted to fucking scorch earth. He wanted to, you know, he's pulling people in a lot of different directions. I'm not going to get into that, but I could see it, you know, if you watch him. And he was a destructive force. I'm glad he's gone. Fuck him.
I'm glad he's gone, and then fuck him too. I'm glad he's gone too. You know, I thought he was funny when he was here, but like clearly the whole time that he was here, you know, looking back, he was sitting there plotting like, I can't wait to get away from these guys. I'm so much bigger than these guys. You know, I need to get away from them.
He was smug, Doug.
He truly was. That smug Doug. Cecil, like I said, Cecil had him sussed out. Cecil totally got him down. He knew exactly what was going on, and I didn't listen again. You know, I just didn't listen because my thing was, you know, Comicsgate, Comicsgate, Comicsgate. You know, not is this guy, you know, is this guy bad for Comicsgate? You know, or not? You know, I'm just thinking about what's good for Comicsgate in terms of bringing more people in. So that's, there you go, Suppa Sandwich. I hope that's good. I mean, that's about as detailed as I can get without showing you private messages, which I don't want to do. At a Catch Sound says, check out role-playing books already published that play different scenarios. Netflix's Dark Mirror Bandersnatch is a video version. Guadalupe Varela says, cool cover. You inspire me to make a good comic. Oh, thanks. Christian Chad, thanks for $20. Says, hi, Uncle E. I have a great idea for Iron Man. Can I use the IP to make a comic as long as I don't profit off of it? I'm hoping to bring attention to my future profits if I offer a free product first. Your thoughts? You can make a comic book that... You can make sample pages of Iron Man, I guess, as long as you don't make a product. Marvel might come after you, but maybe they probably won't.
If he's not making money off it, they won't come after him. Like if he just gives it out for free, it's basically just a fan comic. But like I would tell that, yeah, I would, because Daniel Warren Johnson does it all the time. He did Star Wars and he did some other Marvel property, and he takes them to conventions and quote unquote sells them. Like he says they're free. They cost me $2 to print. If you want to donate, fine, but they're free. So he doesn't really get in trouble for it. But I would tell that dude, make up your own Iron Man.
Yeah. Why can't, if you made up a guy in an iron suit and called him something, why wouldn't you just make up your own version of Iron Man and then own it?
He's just a Kamen Rider. He's the American version of a Kamen Rider.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, by the way. You can come up with new characters, just like you guys were talking about speedsters, that Mean Streak one you had. Even my cleaning lady who does my laundry, she gave me a couple speedster nicknames. She calls me Skidmark. She calls me the Brown Streak, which I don't know, maybe because I got a tan.
Yeah.
But I'm not that fast, but she's given me a lot of these speedster nicknames.
All right, Umbrella Guy says, LOL, two accounts got suspended going at Tug, LOL. That's funny. Micah D2 says, can we get Tug on? Tug isn't even in our chat anymore, is he? If somebody would please send Tug the link, that would be fine if he wants to come on. I don't usually invite Tug because Tug has his own channel and he's making bank, you know. So I don't know if he wants to come on here or not. He's thoroughly monetized. That Umbrella Guy says, my mailbox would disagree. Cars in Depth says, make him Jewish and call him Heeb Bro. That was a little, that's a little late night. Plebeian says, EBS here in the UK, the bigger format has been preferred. That's what I think is going to happen in America too. Edder Von Biscayne says, can we get an option for lenticular covers whenever you end up calling, for whatever you end up calling the Rainbow Guy? I got to find out how much they are, Edder. I would love to do that. Now everybody's going to be doing everybody's going to be doing Chromium now, I think. Because once they see Cyberfrog and realize what it is and how pretty it is, I think the next phase of Comicsgate will be Chromium covers. And I encourage it, but make sure that you guys get started in advance. You know, order these Chromium sheets that get turned into covers way ahead of time. Unhinged Crank says, typical Hollywood user, now using Nick's audience. He'll fit in where he needs to fit into. Yeah, absolutely. What would you call him? Like a ladder stepper kind of. You know, Trevor Wright says, holy hell, Ethan, I tried telling you about Doug months ago and you blew me off. Got to say, it's nice to see you finally get it.
Well, he hit us over the head with it, so it's not.
Like, if he had just, I never would have known if he didn't actually try to burn me. Like, this is the thing. I'd be like, yeah, you know, what a great guy, even though he doesn't talk to me anymore. Oh, he just used me? Okay, that's no big deal. No, he wants to turn around and destroy me on his way out. It's like, you know, Doug... Yeah, I've got a pretty good audience here. They kind of like me. I don't think you're going to be able to do that. And I don't mind telling people about you. I mean, I really don't, you know, Doug. I don't mind telling people what you did. I feel I'm 100% comfortable with every aspect of our relationship, every aspect of it. You know, I try to stay that way. I try to stay kind of like above reproach, or at least answerable for the things that I do and the way I treat people. The stuff that you say are lies, and the stuff that I say is the truth. And when you tell lies about me, I tell the truth about you. We'll see who gets hurt worse. Adel Mork Offendoff says, you got me reading comics again. Thanks, Ethan. Now could someone please stop Seth Rogen from fucking up my comic favorites? The Boys and Preacher. I'm no Trumper, but you I dig. Well, thank you, Adel. I hear The Boys TV show is excellent. Have any of you guys watched it yet?
Yeah, I finished it last night or this morning. Yeah. I loved it. There was only probably one episode that was like egregiously, you know, left wing, where it was kind of like an anti-Christian episode where it was more anti- I don't know, like those big, I think they have them like in the Midwest, like big gatherings. It's almost like Woodstock for Christian bands. And so they had like a thing like that where they were making fun of that.
Hmm.
But that was one episode. The rest of it was solid. It was good. I really enjoyed it. I never read the series. I like Garth Ennis, but I never read The Boys. But so I really liked it going in completely not knowing what the story was about at all. I loved it.
Yeah.
Recommended.
I have the books here. I got to read them, you know, and the TV show, you know, it comes highly recommended. Matt Becker says, I roasted Doug in those old streams and I meant it. Comrade Commissar Yuri says, talking of refunded comics, anyone else get refunded for backing the Relic Shadow of the Light comic today? I don't know what that is. Gonzo the Great says, Dungeon Class is the freshest D&D channel out there. James Dean Anderson says, I am a Christian and a Comicsgate creator. Still grateful. Midnight in Exile says, are you sure you want to go with when your comics gate shut your mouth? Did I say that? Is that a quote? I don't know if I said that or not. When your comics gate, Donald, shut your mouth.
Well, now that's been clipped. All right.
Donald, shut your puppet's mouth when your comics gate.
Yes, sir. Will do.
No, I don't want to go. Oh, I know what I said that about. I meant about your, you know, your views. I don't mean it like that. I take that back. You don't have to shut your mouth.
My abuse. Know? I do need to shut my mouth sometimes. I say words that get me suspended when I start my campaigns.
Somebody I was talking to was like, I think Donald is hilarious on Twitter. The artist I was talking to, he's not, you know, he's not a Comicsgate. He's like, I love Donald. Sometimes he says things though, and I'm just like, what did he say that for? I'm like, because he's Donald. What are you going to do? but he's just like, Donald's funny. E says he came in broke and left rich thanks to Comicsgate, frowny face emoji, and then vomit emoji.
Tell that artist I said thank you, and I hope I like your art.
You do. You know who he is. Adam Mork Offdell says, what nonsense. I am an anti-theist, and I know very well that you're Christian and a Trumpist. You still make sense, so I put money in your pocket because you entertain me and can't wait for Cyberfrog. Yeah, I rarely talk about Trump, you know. I think I talk about people hating Trump crazily more than I talk about me liking Trump, because I don't even know if I like him right now. I'm not sure. I want him to win, but I don't know if I like him. I'm not sure if I liked him ever. except for some things that he said were really funny. And I did want him to build the wall, but I'm not getting a wall. So I said when he was elected, I said, yeah, we're going to get a wall. Of course, that's going to be the easy thing that he's going to do. And that'll be cool. It's like building the Hoover Dam. You know, it's a big American project. And no, we're not getting a wall. You know, that's really strange. I don't like that. I'm voting Democrat next year because I didn't get a wall.
Whoa.
You heard it here first. No. Build my wall.
Build a laser fence.
Oh, I would like that.
And put sharks with freaking laser beams next to it.
And build a moat.
I don't want to get bad ideas out, but a minefield would probably be the cheapest way to do it.
And the most fun.
Shit.
That's awful. That is awful. Peter Armstrong says, I bought Doug's book and regret it. So disappointed. Razdoc says, Edwin says Lim deserves an apology. No, he doesn't. He doesn't deserve an apology at all. Did Lim apologize to Cecil for the whole glove thing?
No.
Tim Lim, there's something up with him. There is something broken about Tim Lim. He received some mild criticism from me that wasn't even directed at him, just the idea of doing Donald Trump comics. And he has turned that into a hate campaign against me, the likes of which only a jilted ex-former lover would be able to match. I have never seen anything like this weirdo. And I've tried to kind of figure out what's wrong with Tim many times. And he is not making it plain to me. There's just something wrong with him. And you can say, well, he just doesn't like you. He thinks that you're involved in this or that. And it's like, well, that's okay. Got it. What's with the whole glove and fist gay ops thing that he did?
Yeah, that was weird.
You know what I mean? Like, that's mentally ill. Tim, you're a doctor. That was mentally ill. You're a weirdo. F you. David Cook says, as a fellow Christian, Dirt Dog has been a huge disappointment. He's on the same level as the multimillionaire TV evangelist. Fake. I feel like I got robbed. Well, if he didn't put his Christian views out there for you to know, then you would never know.
He's the Ted Haggard of Comics Gate. That's what I call him.
Yeah.
You know who Ted Haggard was?
No.
Was? No, I don't.
He was a televangelist. He was caught in a hotel with a male prostitute smoking crack.
Oh.
Who hasn't been?
Yeah. I know, right?
But he was also very like anti-gay. Like that was his whole agenda, preaching.
Hey, Cecil, can I get you to say he's a doctor? He helps people. He helps people. He's a doctor.
First of all, little Caesar, you don't know what you're talking about. Tim Lim is a doctor. If I was in trouble, I would call Tim Lim and he would help me because he's a doctor.
But he said, what is he really, though? What is Tim's actual?
He's an audiologist.
What does that mean? You check your ears?
He checks your ears.
Yeah, I don't know what the fuck.
Ear, nose, and throat doctor.
No, he's not an ear, nose, and throat. He's not an ENT. No,
he's just an ear. Just means
he just tests his hearing. It's not actually an MD. It's not. I had to explain this to a comic book cut that he's not an MD. A doctor is just more of a polite title for what he does. He's an audiologist.
A comic book hut has gone off the rails, by the way. He's so funny. Like I go every single day, I do a Google search on myself and there are like three videos about me from comic book hut. And I'm just like, dude, you're going hard for somebody with 50 subs. You are going hard.
He did a whole thing today where it was him as a character doing multiple characters. I'm fucking completely fascinated by it.
I gotta admit. See, the whole thing is though, you need to see the picture of him. Like that's when you did the interview with him, that destroyed him because of the photograph of him that went along with it. Like when you see him and you see this little guy and he's sitting there going, calling Richard C. Meyer Weirdo Ricardo.
Where's Roberto Ricardo, and also Richard Mitch Breed, Diva Breitweiser, where's our book?
Mitch the Diva. Oh God, it's funny. All right, so in any case, Yethna P says, everyone, where can we publicly post all links to evidence for this stuff? Vids, streams, tweets. Also, everyone, please be open to posting DMs. This is not to hurt Doug, only to expose the lies. It just seems underhanded. I mean, if somebody posts my DMs, I'll counter them. with proof that those DMs have been edited or whatever in some way. But it just, it does seem underhanded to post private messages. Now, having said that, the way to conduct yourself at all times when you're speaking to people privately is with full awareness that your DMs will be exposed. So, you know, that's when I talk to people in private, I have to think everyone's going to see this one day. So I better just, you know, keep my mouth shut. Comicsgate, keep your mouth shut. Thundercat says, thank you for responding to my Twitter DM today. You're welcome. Nathan's here. Timecode Mechanics says, I just did a video about this kind of thing. I didn't even know this was happening. I missed so much. I can't believe he did all that. Good riddance. Yeah. Well, we tried it. This is the thing. Like, I don't want drama and I don't want to get in a big fight with Doug. But he's getting in a fight with me, you know. What's he doing hanging out with all those people who hate me now? Like Amazing Adam, like
Legion of Doom.
I don't know. I've asked Doug some of those, you know, like, but he finds Adam entertaining, and
he does.
Yes,
he finds people with mental disabilities entertaining.
I'm glad he finds that amusing. You know, I hope that makes him laugh. We just laughed at Comic Book Cut though, so
he'll be on that panel for sure.
He's stupid. He's not mentally challenged.
I loved his video about how dare I make fun of Sting. That was the weirdest video. Cecil,
I want to get him up to like 5,000 subs. So when I make fun of him, people know who the hell he is. We got to get him up.
We're trying. Well, I mean, this is a good way to do it. You know, I mean, we got how many people are watching right now? We got 2,000 something, I think. Okay. But yeah, go subscribe to Comic
Book Cut. There was a Little Caesar, Ida Menskaiva. He said, fuck the police. But when he sings it, he thinks of Sting. Gordon Sumner. No.
And now you got to talk about the history of the police and how they are connected to an actual police department. And then tell us what you bought for dinner that day.
Right.
I can't get through one of his damn videos.
Because what happened was they played a show at Shea Stadium, home of my beloved Mets. And at that point, they realized they had nowhere to go. They had to break up at that point. And it was the beginning of a brand new day. I'm going to play that song
for you. I can't make a funny joke. I thought that was a funny joke. When, you know, when NWA sings Fuck the Police, I think about Sting's old band. You know, it's No,
that was funny. I laughed.
Whatever. So a whole video about that, a whole video about my horrible taste in music because I don't like the police. And by the way, I don't like the police. Don't stand so close to me. Or what's that one? Sending out an SOS to the world. Sending out an SOS to the sending out an SOS.
Wrong idea. Wait, who sings that?
That's the police. I couldn't be worse. Wow. Rocks.
Well, isn't "Don't Stand So Close"? Isn't "Don't Stand So Close to Me" a pedo song?
Oh, yeah. Whoa!
Yeah, it is.
Where did that come from?
Anyway, I like the police.
I mean, rock.
You like the police with a turn on the red light, turn on the red light, turn on the red light, Roxanne, turn on the red. You like that?
Well, not
I love that shit.
I love it when Eddie Murphy does it in 48 hours.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Eddie killed that shit in 48 hours. Yeah.
I mean, he's no Frankie Avalon. I'll give you that.
Frankie Avalon, meanness, if you will. That's beautiful music. Mm-hmm. You would have had a good time, Cecil. Gunstown Inhale says, if he screws Nick, I will never forgive Doug. I think Nick is somebody that Doug could use for a long time. So I don't see him screwing Nick. You know, I see him recognizing that Nick has a big platform and is a lawyer. That's somebody that Doug could use. Marta Media, and Nick will probably keep him around too. Marta Media says, ran over a mayonnaise packet when pulling through the Burger King drive-thru and some mayo shot up onto the cashier. Funniest dang thing I ever saw. Wrap your whoppers, fellas. That's brilliant. Milk.
It's like that scene when Jodie Foster was visiting Hannibal Lecter. She got a face full from Migs.
That wasn't mayonnaise.
Yeah. That's our boy Migs.
Greg Bowen says, yeah, Migs. Greg Bowen says, hi, Council tonight. I think so. Yeah, I haven't heard from any of the guys. But, yeah, you know, last week I did it an hour late because I completely forgot about Council. But it is supposed to be it's supposed to be Jeff's night tonight. So I'm sure he'll let me know. Lucky Wookie says, let it go, Uncle E. We've all been here and watched this play out. We're not stupid. I work hard for my cash. I know where to spend it. You're safe. Thanks, Chucky. Cool Tactics says, why is everyone in chat crapping on Doug? Did I miss something? Is it just not putting out Comicsgate on Earthworm Jim? He had to contractually secure the rights.
No, that's bullshit. Mm.
That's not true.
Rewatch the stream and you'll know why.
Yes.
First of all, he said he couldn't be with Comicsgate because it's too controversial. No kidding. His comments were probably the most controversial things in Comicsgate, his anti-gay shit. So what the fuck was he trying to avoid?
Comicsgate is too controversial for me to be around. Heather, you're a good man.
Oh, that was good. Yeah, so Doug has a whole thing where he was yelling at this reporter who was transgendered. Her name was Heather, and he refused to acknowledge, you know, that she was a female or that she wanted to be called she. And so Doug kind of went, Heather, you're a good man. And then went on and on and on about how he refused to just be nice. I don't know what the big deal is with trans people. I mean, I'm not crazy about, you know, just advocating for gay rights. But on the other hand, trans people, they just want to be called she. Go ahead. What are you messing around with for?
First of all, right. And one or two times a year, you're going to encounter one. Just fucking play along. Who gives a shit?
That's right. You know, for goodness sakes, man in a wig. That was great too. But anyway, that's controversial. That stuff is controversy when it comes to the mainstream. Comicsgate, to me, there's no calling Comicsgate controversial is ridiculous. What's controversial is what's going on to mainstream comics right now. That some girl can call the EIC of Marvel Comics a racist and then find herself with a job over there. That is what's controversial. That is the condition of the comic book industry. What's controversial is that this once great, you know, American art form and industry is now full of people who don't care about it, who are using it as political and social platforms to espouse their crazy views while the quality goes down, the price goes up. People are out of work. They've killed the comic book industry. That's what's controversial. Our response to that, saying stop it, no more of that, is the opposite of controversial. That's normal. So calling comics get controversial gets under my skin. Kay Brady says, here's the thing. Rainbow Brood is going to get Cecil his own townhouse. You may not like those apples, but you're going to eat them.
I probably won't like the town either. Mm.
Cecil lives better than in a townhouse right now.
Yeah, why move out?
There's no reason. Adam Mork Offdahl says, by the way, never read Green Lantern before, but love Rebirth. Keep up the fight. Never SJW. Unhinged Crank, a scientist, inventor diagnosed with lung cancer, built his own iron suit to keep his lungs clear and becomes a superhero known as the Iron Lung. That's good. It's close. You know, it's close, but it doesn't infringe. D Loves All Things says, it feels like Doug is trying to segment your audience and get your Christian fans. Yeah, sure. There are a few people that are doing that.
100%.
You know, it's like, or I don't know if he wants them, but he doesn't want me to have them. That's what it feels like. E says, you introduced him to Quartering, to Nick, and to all creators and their audience he never had access to, and it's scumbag of him to say CG didn't help him. Adam Mork Offadal says, by the way, more of my money would come your way if you go digital. International shipping's a drain. Yeah, I'm not going to go digital, not for a long time. It's too easy to pirate. And it runs counter in a way to what I'm doing, what I think about. Like, I just want to produce a comic book, you know, not just comic book stories. I want to produce a comic book that's beautiful.
Agreed.
Yeah. Liam Gray says, I think deviating further than Rainbow Brute will only hurt the market appeal of the parody. Have courage, EBS. It's clear parody. Adam Mork Offdahl says, I'm putting a minefield around my Finca FML. David L says, where's my e-tron emoji, Uncle E? Queen B says, Doug is a stream killer. I only back Bigfoot Bill because of you. He screwed me out of my sketchbook, and I live in the U.S. Never again. Love you, EBS. Oh, thanks, Queen B. That's a shame. Sauce Musta says, Uncle E, funding was approved. We are getting the wall being built as we speak. Don't make the biggest mistake of your life by voting Democrat. never fucking voting Democrat. I don't really. Dracula could be running as the Republican. I'm still voting Republican. Razdok says the chat is angry for you saying you're voting Dem. Guys, it was a joke. My God, you got to know me better than that. Mark C says, I love the Police, but Sting has a habit of creating songs about stalking women. Adel Mork Ofdal says, your backyard kind of reminds me of Tony Soprano's. Is it a New Jersey thing or our this thing of ours thing? By the way, purchase Jawbreaker's Hell of a Marketeer. I live in the kind of neighborhood that Tony Soprano's house is. So the houses all kind of look like his neighborhood, his house around here.
It's not a Jersey thing. It's a fat guy thing.
Oh, yeah. Cecil, I walk outside. First of all, I've smoked a cigar in my backyard in my bathrobe.
You've done it. You've made it. There's nowhere to go.
Did you have a gold necklace on?
No, I don't. Oh, I'm not even wearing one right now. I don't have a gold necklace at all, but I want one.
Ooh, didn't you have gold sunglasses, though?
Yes.
Oh, that would have been perfect.
So I will, gold sunglasses, gold necklace, gold chain. Hunter's got one. I got him a gold chain for Christmas because he's, you know, and he wears a white wife beater around with the gold chain hanging out.
Oh, no.
Yeah. Let's see. K. Brady says, starting to see Comicsgate is right back to where it always was. People crapping on it and making fun of it.
Hutt just showed up. Yay.
Who just showed up?
The Hutt. He does his lightning strikes in the chat. And then he says,
oh, the Hutt's in here?
Yeah, but he leaves. He doesn't. He won't respond. I love you.
He's such a pussy. He's just like, I'm like, Hutt, just come in here. And he's like, and then, like, he doesn't. He runs. Like, what are you afraid of?
He's not going to elevate you. He explained it.
I see.
He'll elevate you.
Yeah, he's not gonna let his 50 viewers know that you exist.
Oh, Comic Book Hutt, you dear chubby man. You're allowed in here. You can talk shit in here. We're not gonna hurt you. Nobody's gonna hurt you, Comic Book Hutt. We like you. We kind of, in a way, feel sorry for you. So anytime you want to come in, you are welcome. And I understand that you have your image to protect.
Let us love you.
Let us love you. James Dean Anderson says, Ethan, you're racist somehow. Now hire me. Gone.
Yeah, how much of that had to do with, CB's thirst? Thirst for the Oriental ladies.
It's negging. Like, no, CB Cebulski, which does not stand for complete bastard. CB Cebulski is the lady in this relationship. And most soy boys are. They can get negged. That's how SJWs worm their way in. You know what negging is, John?
What?
Negging is a strategy that alpha males who have learned to hit on women, who have learned to get one-night stands, developed. They realized that women psychologically, like really attractive women, respond better to people being negative about them than they do positive. So you walk up to a girl in a club and just say, hey, how you doing? And then you look down at her shoes and go, oh, you're wearing those shoes. Those are, you know, or something like that. You make a comment going, dude, you have huge earlobes. I wanted to come over and say hello. Something negative that takes them off their guard and makes them think, this guy, you know, I know I'm hot. Like, this guy needs to recognize my hotness. So I'm going to work extra hard to get this guy to give me the attention that I'm used to getting. So that is what negging is. It's a psychological way to pick up. It's what pickup artists use on women.
Right.
It's now being utilized on SJWs, or no, by SJWs on soy boys.
Mm.
So you can be an SJW. You can go up to a soy boy in power, you know, at Marvel Comics or DC Comics and say, you're kind of fucking racist. And now, especially if you happen to be black or you are any other POC, if you are a POC of any kind and you call someone else a soy boy racist, they're going to go out of their way to prove to you that they're not. And that includes emptying their wallet into your hand. They will give you a job. They'll do whatever you want to do to prove to you that they're not racist.
I think he's trying to trade up.
There is no possible way that he would even dream that he is, can have sex with this person. That
Mark my words.
You think work girlfriend?
Yeah. I think, you know, he's going to have to meet up with her and be put on the extra nice act. It's his dream girl.
Yeah. I just think that's what it is. I think it's negging. And you can neg soy boys all day long.
Yeah,
you
know, I can see both. Like, yeah.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
These people. All right. So Laser Pants Toy Junk says, tell us about CyberFrog action figures. How's the progress coming with them? I'm prepared to spend hundreds, maybe $1,000 on them. Shut up and take my money. Ooh, I'd like to. I've done zero work on the CyberFrog action figure, except insofar as to get the turnaround completely done by our boy 3D Robin, who has now created perfect 3D models of both Salamandroid and CyberFrog.
And whoa, so you perfect. Whoa.
Well, I mean, you know, John, nothing's perfect, but, you know, these are really good, you know.
Hyperbole. Hyperbole.
Yeah, I mean, they're pretty. I don't can I find them? Why are there so many songs about rainbows, John?
Because they're so beautiful.
Is that what it is?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, goes right to the soul.
Hold on a second. I'm going to find this that you guys can see. Okay, so this is here we go. This is what happened. So 3D Robin made perfect, perfect 3D turnaround models of CyberFrog and Salamandroid. Here they are. So when the action figures come out, the sculptors are going to be using these as models. So you can flip them all around and see all the anatomy where everything is. This is their scale. So if you picture CyberFrog as, if you were a 6-inch figure here, this guy's like a foot and a half tall, which is going to be incredible.
Yeah, his arm is as big as CyberFrog.
Yeah. I love these guys. They look so good. I'm so, you know, he did a really, really good job of making these guys. So he can put these guys in any position now. Also, I'm going to see if I can get him to put Salamandroid into the little video game he made so you can make him playable. He'd be a playable character.
Did CyberFrog have his thumb out on that fist bump?
I think maybe, yeah. It looks like it. It looks like it. Why? But not on... Did I do that on the... No, I don't know. I don't know why it looks like that. That's weird. In any case, that's what's going on with the action figures. I'm working on the trading cards right now, and the trading cards seem to be like my number one priority because that's the next campaign that's coming out, the trading card set. We've got the box built. We've got the box designed anyway, not built yet. The crate that all the trading cards are going to go in, the wrapper, and then the box that each trading card pack goes in, that's all developed. All the cards are done. I just have to write the info on the back. Like, I have to write all the blurbs. Nice. Stuff's happening. I mean, we are doing stuff, John.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, I got my cards right here. I got to do about 10 more.
10. I can't wait to get your sketch cards. Can you show any of them?
Yeah, if you want to see a couple of them.
I definitely do.
All right.
Why is Donald in here lurking?
I think he's eating dinner.
It's what I do. Whoa. All right. I don't have... I haven't done my hair or anything here, guys.
We don't. That's okay.
We don't want to see you. We want to see the sketches.
Okay. All right.
I want to make that clear. You understand that, right?
I understand. All right.
Oh, you promised. Look what you did.
Look how beautiful John is. Wow.
Boom.
Dude, that is awesome.
Yeah. Hold on. I got a really cool one. Salamandroid. Look here.
Yeah. Yeah. Damn, that's cool.
Yeah, that one was fun.
These are original art, guys.
Yeah, I went back on all of them. I added more and more details to them.
Oh, my God. Nice.
Are those colored?
Not yet.
I didn't think so.
Black and white, my friend. This is my, I think you've seen this before, Ethan, my Evangelion-inspired one.
No, I haven't seen that. It's gorgeous. Yeah,
so, you guys good. Like Evangelion, the anime, you'll see a remnant... it's a little reminiscent of it.
That looks great.
So you guys have to understand, like, what these trading cards are that John is showing you. Are they? You get if you buy a pack of cards, you get two cards, two art cards in them, two original art sketch cards. They could be John's. You know, John's going to do what, 25? Or what do you think?
Yeah, 25 of them. 25 for sure.
So John's going to have 25 original art sketch cards circulating around this set. I'm going to have 200 of them. We've got a bunch of cards from, I haven't gotten Mike's cards yet. I know we did them and he never sent them to me.
Did Doug ever do his?
Doug never was invited.
Oh,
fucking right.
No, it wasn't personal. I just knew he was busy. He's like, I'll do a card for your set. And I'm like, it's not like that. You know, it's not like the cards themselves are not guest cards. They're all my artwork. It's the sketch cards that we're looking for, you know.
So, yeah, and these will be all colored too. So when you guys get them, when you get these cards, they won't be in black and white. So I got these little alcohol markers to color them up on. Mm. And yeah, they should be pretty awesome.
I got to go get watercolors for mine this weekend.
Mr. Helm,
you got some too, right? You got some cards?
Yeah, 25.
Did you do any of them yet or no?
I penciled a few of them. It's really light. They won't really show up on my crappy camera. Nobody can show them.
Matthew Lemon says, how many per pack? How many cards per pack? Let me see if I can find. Hold on a second here. I'll show you.
Andrew's were looking pretty rad too.
Andrew Huertas?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Some of the ones he's shown in the green room. Yeah. Freaking crazy. Andrew Huerta is amazing talent, man.
What about Art T. Bear? Is he doing any?
No, not that I know of. I didn't ask him. I don't think I asked him. Hold on a second. But, I mean, I would like him to. I got a folder with all of the Cyberfrog stuff so far, like all the stickers and everything and the bookmark. Hold on a second here. All right. We'll go through all this for people who haven't seen it yet. I'll turn the camera on. All right. So this is the Cyberfrog window cling sticker. This is my favorite thing that we made, I think. Maybe. I don't know. So I'm going to destroy one of these. Yeah, look how cool that is. I mean, it's just like, and it's stretchy. Plastic, you can stretch it.
So that's for your car, right?
Yeah, or your window, whatever it is. It's a window cling. You can put it on your mirror. You know, I don't know.
Does everybody that backed the book get one of those?
Yeah, yeah. If you bought one copy of Cyberfrog Blood Honey at any tier, any level, any campaign, you get a Cyberfrog window cling sticker. So that's on its way. I got those already. Here's the Cyberfrog bookmark, which is simple. Like, I said, well, how much would it be to put a little tassel on it? And it was too expensive. So I went, all right, that's fine. Because I spent all my money on the trading cards. So this is this was expensive, John.
Really?
It was expensive. It cost $16,000 to do this. To do all the cards and then put them in these packs. Because I didn't promise people they'd be, you know, bound up in these packs. I just did that because Doug Tenaple did it. And I was like, I want to do that too. I wouldn't have even thought of that. So on the back of this, this is kind of a promo for the upcoming trading card set. These are two cards that you'll only be able to get via the Indiegogo campaign. If you backed at any level, if you bought a copy of the comic, you're going to get at least one of these. There are only two cards, Cyberfrog and Salamandroid. And it says the full set includes, let's see. Oh, no. Okay. So every pack includes, when you get the thing, two base cards, and there are 18 base cards total. One autographed card, probably by me. One line art or throwback card, one puzzle card, and two sketch cards. That's the big thing. The sketch cards are the big deal. And it's going to be really, really cool. They've got the artwork for the front of this all done up. It's different than this, but it looks similar. I think it's the just regular Cyberfrog jumping drawing. The box is all done. So there's that. Of course, there is... Cyberfrog Vampirella is shipping. Right now, it's fulfilling. So if you ordered one, you've got one of these coming. This campaign is closed. And we've got, of course, the Cyberfrog Chromium. Let's see. So basically what I did, this is what it's going to look like, except it won't say proof copy on it. It's going to look like this. Okay. This is the book. This is going to open up to an All Caps Comics sketch comic cover page. And I'm going to, if you have a ordered a sketch for me, I'm going to draw a Cyberfrog head sketch and sign, and I'm going to sign every single one of them here so that I won't ruin your beautiful Chromium cover. I won't sign the cover. But this is what the Cyberfrog book is going to look like when you get it. Dun, dun, dun. All right. And then this, of course, is the, let me take this out. This is the Salamandroid version, Chromium version of, and these are the rare one. This campaign was only open for 8 days. And so people who didn't jump on this didn't get one. We are printing 12,000 of these and only 3,000 of these. So if that gives you a relative scale. If you bought one of these, good for you. It was only open for 8 days and it closed. So there's no other way to get this. And then the current book that's coming out that I don't even have a sample of yet, I should be getting that soon, is the Fist Bump Team Up variant, which is right behind me. And if you haven't purchased one yet, it's not Chromium. Let me make this clear. The Chromiums are only the first two campaigns. This one is going to be a nice cardstock cover. And it's going to be a nice package. All of the perks are included. You're going to get the sticker. You're going to get the bookmark. You're going to get the trading card. If you go to the $50 tier, you're going to get the ash cans, the two ash cans. That is the cover on it. That is available right now, and the link is in the description. So you still have a little bit of time to buy Cyberfrog Blood Honey.
That one's square bound, right?
I think so. Yeah. I told them I wanted it to have a spine, and they said, all right, we'll look into that, you know, so.
Oh, by the way, the Hut just put up a new.
Did he really?
Yes. And the best part is the thumbnail is a picture of you right now. Like, it's you from this. it's you. It's called, the name of the video is Ethan Van Sciver, Enemy of the People.
You gotta be kidding me. Enemy of the People.
Let's roast it live.
You got to comment on it now.
You don't think that's going too far? Enemy of the People? The People? All right, hold on. Let me look him up. The comic book. Does this guy, is he just joking? Why is he be clowning himself?
Let him go.
All right, hold on. Let's find out.
Please don't stop him.
I know. I don't want to stop him at all. Comic book hut, do not run away. Keep going. You're doing good work.
Yeah, don't delete your channel for a sixth time.
Yeah. All right. So let's see here. I'm gonna share this. Bump. All right. And I'm gonna have to aim it just at me. These are all the super chats I'm looking at right now. All right. And I'm gonna turn on the volume. Are we gonna watch this?
Yeah.
How long is it? Oh, it's only 12 minutes.
Only Jesus.
When it stops being funny,
the great one, the spectacular one.
We haven't even been streaming for 12 minutes.
All right, let's have a look. He's got 51 views already.
Yeah, that's my mug. I see my face on it.
By the way, thank you guys. You got him up to 96 subs. Four more, he's going to get to 100. So, all right, let's see. Hi, everybody. This is
the great one, your host, The Hut. So today, Ethan Van Sciver had a very great message to all his people on Twitter. And I'm going to have to really surmise and really very
shut your mouth
way here at the Hut. You know all about that sacrifice? Yes, we've learned today how much Ethan Van Sciver has sacrificed for all of us. He's put himself in a position where he's taking all the hits. He's taking all the risks. He's a very saintly figure. He might take over as the greatest saint besides Saint Edwin the Pious here in
Why is he picking on Edwin too? Everybody has a nickname. When did Hut become like enemy of Comicsgate? Like full scale, like everyone. It should just be me and Weirdo Ricardo.
And I see Mike over there on the side looking all depressed. On his hotel examinations. That's an odd
clip. That's a good thumbnail. That'll drag him in. I want to see what's going on.
Oh, Umbrella Guy's live right now, by the way. He's got a picture of Tim Doyle in his bikini. Tim Doyle explained that, by the way. We'll get back to Hut in a second. Tim Doyle explained that, like, you know, you make fun of me, but like I was at a movie producer's house at that moment and he asked me to do that. I was like, that doesn't make it better, Tim.
No.
Yeah,
no.
You just say no.
That makes you his bitch.
Have some dignity.
He wanted to make fun of you. He saw you and thought you were the biggest idiot in the world and was just like, can you get in this green string bikini just for laughs so I can take a picture of you and your big fat pancake nipple titties. And you, what was that noise?
That was me laughing.
I'm messing with the volume. Yeah, so that like, is
like you're at a movie producer's house and somehow that makes it okay. You know, oh, I was at a construction guy's house. He told me to put on this bikini. I was like, yeah, all right.
But it was just like, don't you understand? I'm hanging out with like movers and shakers in Hollywood. And it's like, and they're making fun of you. Like,
KSSS in the chat says that producer's name, Harvey Weinstein.
Brian Singer. He's a little too old for Brian Singer. All right. Do we go on with this? I'm already bored.
No, they're not good. I mean, they're not like, that's the problem. They're not good, but
I like seeing my name.
It's comforting that they're there. Even the one he did about me the other day, I didn't actually make it through. And that was all about me, but I didn't, it's not, it's just comforting to know he's out there doing them. I don't actually have to watch them.
Yeah, I want to watch him. I but he is really goddamn boring. And all right, let's give it a thumbs up. An ironic thumbs up for Comic Book Hut, God's sake. Yeah. Thank you, Jabba the Cuck, for loving this video. Finally, the truth is spoken.
You're definitely blocked. There's no way.
No. He wants me to see his videos.
No, I can't leave comments. I'm blocked.
Are you serious? He blocked you?
Yes, you're definitely blocked. 100%.
He blocked Yellow Flash too. I mean, it's like, yeah.
Why would he block me? So I'm blocked from commenting.
Well, I mean, you'll find out in a second.
On there.
If I refresh, I'm not going to refresh this.
Oh, it showed up. Wait a minute. Comment showed up.
You're not showing up on mine, though. You're showing up only on yours. Yeah, you don't realize you're blocked.
Comic Book Hut, why are you such a bitch? Why won't you let me talk? Like, what is your problem? Surely me interacting with you as you make these videos is what's entertaining and attractive to people. You don't think people want to see me respond to your dumb videos? They do.
I don't need to add my clout to you, Ethan Van. Little Caesar, as I call you. I spell it L-I-L, Little Caesar.
You do it perfectly.
Page, I don't see your comment.
Oh, all right. Well, Comic Book Hut, message received. You know, loud and clear. You know, I must be the only guy in the world who has videos like this up on Twitter about him. So, like, Ethan Van Sciver, enemy of the people.
And then you can't even comment on it. You're blocked. Yeah.
Does this happen to other people, or is this just me?
Just you.
Andrew just walked by and said, just you. She's laughing.
Please give Andrew my love. Please. Oh,
she closed the door. She comes up. Like, Andrew is so funny. Like, I'm like, will you please come on the show? And she's like, like, she's really, really shy and nervous. But every now and then, I'll force her to kind of say something that people can hear. People just want to know she's there and that she hasn't left me because I'm the enemy of the people. Mm. Get out now, Andrea. You know, black helicopters are coming for me.
Yeah.
Driven by or commanded by Comic Book Hut. The enemy of the people.
I love that I gave the history of your throwaway joke. I think of the police when I made him give a 12-minute video on the history of the police. Fucking crazy.
What was that for, dude?
Completely insane.
Let me just look at his. Can we look at his? Let me look at his whole channel. I mean, if his whole. Oh my God. I'm not even kidding. It's all my face. hold on a second now. His entire channel is me. Let's see. Share. I mean, look, this isn't right. Like, this content. All right. So, Ethan Van Sciver, enemy of the people. Area 51 knows where Richard C. Meyer is. Ethan Van Sciver attacks OG Comicsgate. Then, weirdly, there's a video about the Mets. Ethan Van Sciver gives an example of his writing style. This is me playing Wolverine is gay live. With a couple of guitarists backing me up behind me there.
I bet in that Mets video he yells at you for not being a Mets fan.
Just click on the videos on the top and you'll see all of them at once.
All of them at once? Okay, hold on. This will be better. All right, good. I'm glad. All right, so here we go. Rainbow. Oh, by the way, you're a childless weirdo.
Cecil. Yes, yes. I've been
told. Sabotage, Ethan MacGyver, see ya moment, cover your ass moment, and super chat extravaganza. Like, probably somebody sent me a super chat and got me to say something embarrassing. So this is a video. Oh, there's Mitch. Something about Mitch. Rainbow Brute Writer Cecil. He's after you, too.
He's got my number.
Ethan MacGyver, what did he know in the way? Ethan MacGyver's Fall of Rome live stream commentary. Ethan MacGyver, go back to where you came from, question mark. This is all my answer to being invited to Comic Artist Pro Secrets. We're going to get another one of those videos. Will you back up? So you are childless weirdo Cecil. That's who you are now.
So he has kids?
I don't know if Comic Book Club has kids. I can't imagine he has kids.
Oh, man, if he's bred, that's bad.
Nah, that guy fucks, man.
Oh, man.
Never-ending story, Ethan MacGyver's pity victim party. Why would I think I'm a victim? Where would I get the idea that I'm a victim of anything? There's no reason for me to think that. Mitch Breitweiser's futurist partner. So Mitch is in here too. I like the videos about Mitch. I also like the videos about Weirdo Ricardo too, because it's the same picture of him scratching his neck every time. Ethan MacGyver is great at burning bridges. The search for Richard C. Meyer leads to Little Caesars. I guess that's me, because I'm.
Oh, he does. He does like little comedy sketches.
He does.
Oh my God! Yeah, the Area 51. Let me see how many minutes I made it in. I made it almost 5 minutes into it, but four minutes. But it's painful. He has characters. He has the Army base commander. It's him and a woman that he calls Edna, and he does like a 1940s radio show with it.
Dude, is his mom watching him? I mean, are his parents watching him and making sure he's okay? I mean, this is. That sounds really strange. I got to watch some of these. All right.
That was the second one from today, not the one that he just put up. He put this one up, at 7 o'clock this morning.
Exactly. Wait a second. This is how many days? This is 5 days, 5 days worth of video.
Most prolific YouTuber since Zach.
He did two weeks ago.
I thought this was one a day.
No, everything is a week old except for two of them. He did two weeks ago, and then every other video is within the last week.
All right, let me see what else we got.
7 days.
Yeah, Zach's looking at his upload schedule like, God, I got to get to work, man.
Because Ethan MacGyver controls his GoFundMe, Richard C. Meyer cannot get out of Comicsgate. That is clickbait, and that belongs on the cover of like one of those tabloids on your way out of a supermarket, I don't control Richard's GoFundMe. The money goes right into his bank account. That's how GoFundMe works. YouTuber Ethan MacGyver attacks legendary musician Sting. Really? Really?
Blistering attack.
Mitch Breitweiser with the Muppets chickens behind him here, looking perplexed. Ethan MacGyver hates cherries. Let me help. Ew. Have you seen Richie? Ethan MacGyver and Mike S. Miller complain. Hostility in comics. Jawbreaker's God King. So basically, we're big stars to Comic Book Hut, I think. We're all pretty much. Yeah. There's nothing on you, John.
I'm disappointed. It's always nice to be recognized, and clearly I'm not being recognized.
Combo Cut, why don't you hate John Malin?
Please?
Comic Book Cut, you're not doing your job. Certainly there are many reasons to hate John Malin.
Hundreds.
What do you think of Sting, John?
He's terrible.
What?
Sting? Yeah.
I mean, even I hate John Malin.
See? Yeah. I'm easy to hate, Hutt. Come on. Don't
show me his Thunder art.
Oh,
by the way, we just gave him his second biggest video. He's got 243 views on this because we're shouting it out. But his biggest video is, will you buy a book written by a childless weirdo? It's Rainbow the Brute, and that's you, Cecil. 431 views. Let's scroll down and see if we can top that.
I put asses in seats, Ethan.
Yes, you do. Mostly yours.
Yeah. Fat ass.
That's his number one video, is will you back a book by written by the Chalice Word? By the way, I take that as a compliment. He put Rainbow the Brute. Everybody wants Rainbow the Brute. You know, it's like they see this book and they go, I'm going to read this. That's a pretty good sign, don't you think? Like,
it's pretty awesome.
Yeah, yeah. It's going to explode when you launch it. It's going to be huge.
I got to say, that is a really good sign. I worry about it. You know, I'm like, I don't know if Rainbow the Brute's really going to, you know, take off.
Your
know?
Haters will buy it so that they can goof on it.
Yeah, but they can't goof on it. It goofs on them. I mean, you know, you can't really goof on a book that goofs on them too much, unless it's really like illiterate. But
I'm just glad it's on a hut on a hut video, because the mistaken top billing I got on that is now recorded for posterity, at least on this
channel. I fixed it. I yelled it. By the way, here's the situation. I'll repeat this whole story, because I told you only when I was drunk and you were drunk.
I started laughing when I thought that. I was like, what?
I told Andrea about it. She's like, did you say that? I'm like, yeah, of course I did. That's how Cecil and I roll. Now, what happened was, hey, Hunter, how you doing? Hello? What happened was, I get this, I get James Dean Anderson, I hired him to design the Rainbow Brute logo, and he did a great job. Like, it's better than I could have hoped for. But in order to show how it looks on a comic book, he mocked up this one little drawing that I did. And he, you know, he made it look like the comic book might look. And he put our names, the names of the creators, down the side of it. And he put Cecil's name first. And I said, John, I said, look, James, dude, Cecil's name would not be first. I understand that he's the writer, but like, I'm the creator, artist, writer. You know, it's like my name would be first.
I'm Ethan Van Driver.
Yeah, I'm Ethan Van. Do you know who I am? Like that. And you know, started to pant and get upset. And I he was like, oh, I can fix it. I just thought the shape worked better. Like, if you look at it, Cecil Van Skyver pokes out. It's the longest name. And then Ritter, it just worked better like that as a shape. So I thought, you know, it's just a sample.
It's aesthetically pleasing. I think it's right. Aesthetically pleasing. I'll go along with that.
Well, that's what he said. And so, but that was not good enough for me. I was furious. Like, my ego, you know, totally got control of me. So I in any case.
Shut up, Comicsgate. He's talking.
Shut him up.
I posted it on Twitter because I just couldn't wait for people to see the logo. And everyone went, Ethan Van Skyver is so humble. He put Cecil's name first. Great guy. What a great guy. And Cecil, I was like,
Van Skyver.
I was like, that's because I love Cecil. And in the meantime, I said, John, I said, James, fix it. My name's first, Cecil's second, maybe third. You want to put it on, put his name on the back cover,
inside cover.
But yeah, but on Twitter, I'm just like, thank you. Well, I mean, he deserves it. Yeah, everyone loves Cecil. Fix it, James, now. So that's the truth of that story. And I had to tell Cecil, because Cecil knew that was coming. Cecil knows me better.
As soon as I saw that, I started laughing out loud.
You know what would be funny, though, is like he would take Cecil's name and put it, like he put Van Skyver and then he put Cecil's name in like really small letters and then Kyle Ritter. That shit would be hilarious.
Just make Kyle Ritter's name like three times as big, you know, as both of ours. Cecil really small, me medium, but Kyle Ritter huge. And actually, I would accept that. James, if you want to do that, that's fine. All right, so... anyway, what is this? Is this mental illness or is this just good fun?
Yes.
No, it's just.
Yeah.
Yes.
I wouldn't sleep in the same room with the man. I can assure you of that. That seems a little obsessive.
Yeah, a little bit weird.
I wouldn't let him watch my kids.
Yeah.
I mean, unless you couldn't get anyone else.
No.
No, I would just leave them by themselves.
Do you know how insane this is?
Watching the kids. What's the babysitter situation over there?
Oh, Hunter's sitting here. All right, let me explain the babysitter situation.
Get the hut to babysit. I guarantee Hunter does not hit him.
Well, Andrea and I were talking about this. Hunter, I'm going to talk about your personal life. Is that okay? Well, you can say, if you don't want me to talk about it, do you care? He says, go ahead. But he said it a little bit like,
go ahead. Like he's going to resent you in 5 years.
Hunter is getting girls. Hunter is getting girls. He's got the car. He's got the looks. He's got the build. He's got the gold chain around his neck. Yeah, he's got a gold chain. He's got gold.
Is he a rapper? What
the fuck? He's from Jersey.
No, it's Italian. It's a cross, you know.
Oh, okay.
That's yeah, worst. He's from Jersey.
Mm.
So he's doing great. He's got girls. The story goes like this. So me and Andrew are always like, oh, we need somebody to babysit Ava. She's 3 years old. We can't do anything. We can't date unless we get a babysitter. And we've mostly gone to Andrea's big sister, but her big sister smokes. And, you know, the house smells a little like cigarette smoke when she leaves. We love her. We appreciate it. But not only that, like, we can't ask her all the time. Like, we want to date twice a month, like go to concerts and casinos. And we can't just be like, come over and watch Ava. We need to actually find a babysitter who's professional, who we can pay. Okay. And that's something so that we can go out whenever we want. Hunter's like, I know just the person. So Hunter brings over this 20-year-old girl named, I won't say her name.
Candy. Crystal.
No, I like Candy better, John. Go back. It helps the fantasy.
These are stripper names.
Now, Hunter brings her over, and she's nothing like that, but she's kind of pretty in a kind of bookish way. Like, I'm a responsible young lady, and, you know, and we're interviewing her, and she's like, yeah, you know, I work with young children all the time, and, you know, I'm a babysitter. You know, I do it because I love it. She's wearing a T-shirt that says something like Girls Club or something like that. I can't remember what it was. And I said to her, well, what T-shirt mean? And she said, oh, this is like a mentoring kind of club that I started for, you know, teenagers and younger girls. It's kind of like the Big Brother program, but it's for girls. And it's something that I initiated and everything. I'm like blown out by this girl. She's awesome. Okay.
Yeah. I get
blown and
too. Yeah,
I'm sitting there looking at Hunter, who's sitting next to her on the couch. And Hunter's looking at me. Hunter's giving me a look like this. What do you think, Dad? Kind of like that. And I can't tell if he's saying, what do you think? She's a great babysitter, or don't you think she's cute? Like, I can't tell what Hunter's saying to me with his face, but I'm like, you know, she's a great babysitter. Stay away from her. So I'm like, you are fantastic. You're super impressive. You're hired. We need you to start like this weekend. I immediately bought tickets for Frankie Valli, you know, this weekend at the Tropicana. And I'm like, you know, I'm gonna have a great time. Let's go. So he's hired. The next day, Hunter goes, she's kind of hot, huh, Dad? And Andrew and I both, like, together went, stay away from our babysitter. Stay away from our babysitter.
It's like a Lifetime movie title of a. Stay away from her daughter.
Yeah. Stay away from her. We found the perfect babysitter that's going to allow us to have a social life. You know, it's like, do not. And Hunter, you know, Hunter likes the ladies, but Hunter's love them and leave them type. Like, he's occupied with his job. You know, he's busy. He loves his car more than he loves any human being. And he really doesn't, like, he likes girls, but he doesn't want the girls around him all the time. He's like, they're texting me constantly. Like, you know, give me a little space. So Andrea and I are having this nightmare that, you know, Hunter's going to love up our babysitter and then break her heart, and then she's no longer going to be our babysitter. So I told Hunter, under no circumstances is he to date the babysitter. Now, the problem with that is that it did create a sense of intrigue. Yeah, like, what if
just got 10 times hotter?
Yeah, well, and for her, like I can tell she's interested in Hunter too. Like, I could just tell. Otherwise, you know, what is she doing over here?
Oh, I got her a job too.
And Hunter's like, I got her a job too. Great.
Oh yeah.
Where he works. So mm-hmm. So I mean, she could say to him, hey, you know, why don't we go out? And he could say, I'm not allowed. You know, my parents aren't going to let me date you. They specifically said, and that's going to make it even more intriguing for her. She's going to be like, well, we can just be secretive. You know, like, you know how girls are.
Yes.
This is how everybody is. You know, that makes it extra cool, you know, extra fun if you're doing it in secret. Hunter, now this is what we found out today. So that I already told you that part of the story. You guys, if you've been listening, you're aware of that part of the story. Yeah. The new part of the story, Andrea and I are talking today. We're in the pool. She's like, Hunter's ex-girlfriend from high school is coming home today. Hunter had a girlfriend. He really liked her. she moved to Australia because her dad's military. They had to all move to Australia at the same time that he went to Ohio. And she was just like, well, we can date long distance. I'm like, what are you, nuts? Like, in Australia, he's in Ohio. You're not dating long distance, and he's in college. It doesn't matter. They kept in touch anyway, even though they, you know, I assume went their separate ways. She's back in town now. And Andrea and I went. Yes. Yes. She said, how long before Hunter has that girl, his girlfriend, over the house again? I said, tonight. She said, because she's just back. She said, do you want to place a bet? And I said, she said, I'll say tomorrow. And I was like, no, I think it's going to be tonight. First, what will happen is Hunter will come to me and say, what do you think about me dating her again? And I'm going to say, I think it's a great idea, and you should. And then she'll be back in play.
Hunter needs your opinion on these things, Ethan.
Well, he does. Like, he'll ask me. He'll be like, what do you think, Dad? What do you think of this? What do you think of that? You know, and so, you know, I know Hunter pretty well. So what do I think of it, Hunter? I think it's great. You haven't asked me yet.
I'll date them both. I don't care. At the same time.
Did you hear
what he
said? At the same time, yeah.
At the same damn time.
Yeah. Why not both? That's what I was thinking.
Bounchka wow wow. I hope she's
he's in the room. He's going to do the exact opposite of what you want. Why would he do the exact opposite of what I want?
He's got to rebel.
Doesn't make sense to me. If you loved me, you would just date his ex-girlfriend from Australia.
By the way, your babysitter has inspired me with her mentor thing. I am going to do a lot more outreach to single moms in my neighborhood.
Yeah, me too.
That's good.
That yeah, I'm going to start I'm going to start a stripper pole class.
Cecil gives parents. Back.
Hey, can I join, John?
You got it.
Sweet. Cecil gives back. All right, let me finish reading these super chats here. There you go. All right. So which would be worse, says Phil Arconis, the Tom King written New Gods movie
or Ethan cutting out in the middle of a sentence?
You cut out, Ethan.
Oh, because it wasn't just me. I was like, is that just me?
his camera has been going bad for a while now on the stream.
The potato man.
Larry Van Sciver.
We might have lost him. Yeah, that might have been it.
What was the sentence he started? I'll finish it for him.
I don't know. But I need Hunter to bang that sitter and come on Sexy Party and tell us about it.
Well, we don't even know if they really look good. Maybe they're good by Hunter's standards. We don't know what Hunter's standards are.
Hey, man.
I mean, is the Australian girl still hot?
Hmm?
I mean, a good question is the Australian girl still hot, or did she get extremely fat when she was over in Australia eating all that? You know,
no, they're on the beach. Everybody's on the beach in Australia. The only people live on the water only there. Everywhere else.
Yeah, Vegemite crap. Just Bud Light.
Hunter, if you can still hear us, introduce them to each other, you know, just kind of feel it out.
Yeah, man.
See what the chances are.
Just get them drunk.
Let's see how many videos the HUD has put up since we checked.
Get a couple drinks in them. Tell them both you have a hot tub. And then see what happens.
Yeah. While we have this intermission, guys, go back Graveyard Shift. We passed 1,000 backers today. If you like superhero comics with you know, Universal Monsters, if they were the X-Men, this is volume 2. Hop on it, y'alls.
How close are you to 100K?
I think we're at 76 today. So pretty close. You know, probably by the end of the 30 days, we'll hit 100K.
Great.
Fantastic.
You're definitely going to be over by the time the 60 days is up, though.
So yeah. Yeah. Awesome. So we'll be running for a full 60 days. So, yeah, I think it'll be pretty good. I'm putting the link in the chat real quick. David L for $2. Now you're going to have 2 grandkids. Just in case Ethan doesn't make it back, I wanted to be sure your super chat's read there. I don't know if there were any more that went by over the last few minutes. I'm scrolling up real quick.
By the way, I have bad news, bad Comicsgate news. Betty Brighteye left Twitter.
Oh, why?
I don't know. I wasn't around for the last, you know, couple of days. I was this whole weekend I was sailing. And I came back like late Saturday night and then I couldn't really get involved. And Sunday night, I just wasn't around this weekend. So I missed all of the streams. I have to watch all of it, or maybe I won't even bother. I kind of caught up, but I missed all of these streams from this weekend. And so I guess just during the shit, during all the fighting.
Yeah. Ethan says, hold on, guys. So it looks like he's trying to get back in.
I wanted to put a tribute video.
Yeah, I heard you, Ethan. Yeah.
Okay, good.
I wanted to put a tribute video up on YouTube, but it's going to have a song in it. And I don't care if they demonetize it, but I don't want to get struck.
Yeah, that's the thing. Sometimes I don't care about the monetization. It's about the strike.
Yeah. All right, let me read the rest of these super chats guys, before I get thrown off again. Donut Swan's super chat is amazing. He said, strong panel. The last few streams have looked like the Soylent witch trials. Edwin was Robert Mueller trading immunity to Praetorian for dirt on war campaign. Damn, is that dead on? He said, if those combos were the best you can get, you must have quit. Hail Caesar. What do you think of that?
Yeah, and the dirt on war campaign was about Praetorian.
That thing that just strikes me. It's like Praetorian basically sold him, sold out war campaign, all of the stuff that he did wrong, left war campaign, hung out to dry while he apologized and tried to back into normal society. Is that how it works?
Mm-hmm.
I got to tell you, man, the whole thing kind of pisses me off the more I look at it.
What I tell you? Something doesn't stick about the whole thing.
I don't think it's a conspiracy. I just think it's a lot of people under a lot of pressure making poor decisions.
Yeah, no, not a conspiracy. You know? Like, it's not that evolved, but something, it just, the whole thing just felt funny, you know?
I'm being honest, I thought Denali.
What do you mean funny?
Funny, you know, like the way the story goes.
All right, let's see. Chucky, he says, if you're a creator and produce SJW world, give a fook. If it's good, I'll buy it, but not the trash so far. If you're a trash SJW mouthpiece, go away. Not interested. You're wasting all our time. Donut Swan said, I knew Doug was a bad egg when he had Mal Cecil. Damn, dude. Donut Swan's coming to eat. Laser Pants Junk says, are you doing the High Council tonight? Yeah, I think so, if I can. Mike Oxmall says, Malin is a weeb, but is that Eva Frog in the set? EVA Frog in the set. Philo Fish says, work for Tops and Upper Deck and Cryptozoic and would do cards for you if you want. See, I mean... James Dean Anderson says 2-1. The RB is winning. Cool. I need rent money. Atle Mork Offdahl says the boys is TV. S is okay, but F horrible if you like the comics. Same with Preacher. Can't wait for Cyberfrog, Blood Honey, and Vampirella. Chucky Wookie says I bought original art. Can I get the two chromium covers thrown in? I want. Please, I need them. Marcy says Tim Doyle is set to replace Justin Long and Kevin Smith's Tusk too. Jackie Meyer says Jeremy Hambly started a GoFundMe called Tug Baby Fund. I'll put the link in the description. Yeah, maybe I will. James Dean Anderson says, in fairness, I'm 38 of Hut's 96 followers. 39. Unhinged Crank says, hello, Radiant and Andrea. Alan Rogers says, this is like Taxi Driver, but not cool or good. SeedFan85 says, it's not. Shuan Head did a video about the no maps and got a ton of response videos targeting her. Ben Hennessy's here. He says, Comic Book Hut is really Cecil screwing with you. Cecil, is that true? No, you couldn't have done that.
Or could he?
Yeah, that impersonation is pretty dead on.
It is. Atle Mork Offdahl says, Black Hawk Down, SOS. I'm back. Crazy Man in 2003 said, Malin delivered his book. He sure did. Mm-hmm. And Clyde Griffiths is a new member. And thank you very much for joining the channel. Appreciate you. And with that, I'm going to go because I'm afraid I'm going to get kicked off again. I've totally lost my sense of security. But I'm grateful.
In the woods.
Yeah, I cannot wait. I'm supposed to get my internet fixed August 5th, and it's like 14 days that they're making me wait. It's they got to dig up the line. I don't even know. Dig it up. That
well. Kind of silly.
They have to bust up your driveway to do that?
Yeah.
Oh, that sucks.
They told me they have special tools, but I don't believe them.
You don't believe that? How do you
lying? No, how do you?
We got special tools, buddy. Don't worry. Yeah, we'll rip up your driveway.
How do you shoot a line underneath the driveway and up the other side? I don't think so.
They've got hangers that do that. They pull wire.
The hangers that do that?
We used to do it when we work on trucks for pulling stuff on a carpet. They will go on wire and they'll pull it through.
Under the driveway?
Yeah.
Hunter's saying that they can do it, and we'll see. All right, guys, thanks for being here. Appreciate it. And please hit the like on the way out. I'd really appreciate that. And I will see you guys together, I think, for the High Council. Adios.
All right, bye. Bye.